Tallahassee, Florida. Doak Campbell Stadium. Bobby Bowden Field for the final home game of the season for the Florida State Seminoles and their interim head coach, Odell Hagans. They went to BC last week and pulled a stunning upset of the Eagles. 38-31 on the road. Can they follow it up for their seniors? 19 seniors honored today in this final home game. It is ACC College Football, and the matchup today, the Alabama State Hornets out of the Football Championship Subdivision against the Florida State Seminoles on Military Appreciation Day here in Tallahassee. This presentation of ACC College Football is presented by your local Ford dealer. And it is so great to have you with us for our game this afternoon. Tom Wormy along with James Bates. Kelsey Wingert will join us in just a moment from the field. For Florida State, an amazing 2 to 3 weeks of activity around this program. The dismissal of Willie Taggart as the head coach. Odell Hagans take over for the second time as interim head coach. They go to Boston College and get the win. And now just one win away, James, from bowl eligibility for this program.
No telling what was going to happen up on the road, Chestnut Hill. But how about this? 6 days after the turmoil, Willie Taggart being dismissed. Late in the game, here's DJ Matthews, a 60-yard touchdown catch and then dive from James Blackman, the starter that game. Backup quarterback, Jordan Travis getting in there and getting involved in a big way. Three carries, 94 yards, including this 66-yard touchdown run to seal the deal. And it's the Powerade. Make no mistake, it's a Powerade bath around here for three. And Odell Hagans. And this is a senior class being honored here today, the last home game at Doak, that when they signed up back in 2016, this is the previous 4 years, they had seen the Noles win three ACC championships, a national championship, go to the college football playoff. This isn't what they signed up for. This isn't Florida State Seminole football. This pageantry here on the field, this that you're about to feel in Doak Campbell Stadium here in a few moments when they come running out, that's Florida State Seminole football, and it's winning football. It's a winning, positive program, and nobody knows that more than their head man right there, Coach Odell Hagans.
Leads his team onto the field. In our meetings yesterday, all he said was the theme was the love and support of these young men that have committed to this program. Coach Hagans, Florida State, through and through. And for more on Coach Hagans, let's go down to the field and Kelsey Winger.
You know, you will never hear, it is not about me, it is all about these young men, more than you would in a 15-minute conversation with Odell Hagans. This is the 26th season of coaching here at Florida State. He also played here, so he's taking bleeding garnet and gold to a whole different level. And Tom, like you said, the most important thing for him is making sure that every young man in this program knows how much he loves and he cares about him. And they know that. And they've shown his support with this head coaching vacancy in our Toyota Tweets of the Week. Numerous players on this current team tweeting out their support for Coach Hagans, wanting him to get a shot at that full-time job. Now, FSU has said they hope to have this search done by the end of November. But, guys, there seems to be a heavy favorite amongst the team. And a win today to put them in a bowl game will be a first step in that direction of who they will decide going forward.
Absolutely, Kelsey. What a great sit-down we had with him. You can't help but pull for him, and you can't help but be energized. He even took it as far as saying, my favorite quote of the week, maybe of the season, he said, you know what, the only time it's about me is when I'm out there on that lake fishing. This is all about them.
Captains at the center of the field. This is the first ever meeting between these two programs and the first time Alabama State has taken on a team out of the Atlantic Coast Conference. And moments away from Osceola upon Renegade planting the spear. And here's our weather conditions. We told you it's chilly. 50 degrees, feels like it's more in the mid-40s or so. High humidity and 11-mile-per-hour breezes here at Doak Campbell Stadium. Bobby Bowden Field. And moments away from the start of Florida State and Alabama State. Alabama State is 5-4 on the season. They still have a chance to win their division in the SWAC. Florida State won the toss, elected to defer. There's James Blackman, quarterback for the Seminoles. And there's the head coach, Donald Hill Ely, in his third season. He was once an interim coach as well, James. as a former assistant and took over in 2017. The team was 0-5. After that, they won five of their last six games, and then he was promoted to the head coach position. Osceola plants the spear, and we're ready to go. Final home game of the year for Florida State. Again, a win against Alabama State, and they would become bowl eligible. Odell Higgins, as Kelsey mentioned, started here in 1994 as an assistant under Bobby Bowden. Also an All-American defensive lineman, played linebacker as well from 85 to 89. 52 years old from Bartow, Florida. And as James referenced, we had a wonderful conversation, and it ended with hugs.
Yes.
He said, the first time I'm going to hug a gator, talking to James Bates.
Yeah.
It won't be the last.
Well, that's the kind of guy he is, though. You want to give him a hug, and he shows so much love and shows so much heart that you can't, you just want a piece of it. And it means the world to him that these young men have a positive finish here, their last home game in Tallahassee. And they'll get that break, and then they'll head east over to Gainesville, take on the Florida Gators. And after that win with Boston College, and after it looks really good to go back, start a new bowling streak, who knows what can happen. But first things first, we got one here today at high noon.
Parker Grodehouse to put it in the air. It's going to be a shortish kick near the 6-yard line. Ezra Gray on the return up the middle of the field, and Gray all the way past the 45-yard line for Ezra Gray in the return for the Hornets.
Well, starting early. Coach Hill Ely said this is the earliest by far our team has gotten up on game day, making one guy miss and then dragging a few more up to Osceola's head midfield. That's a great way to start by Ezra Gray, the starting tailback that has gotten better as the season has gone on. And here's Kadarius Davis, the quarterback, who's 18 touchdowns and 11 interceptions through the air. Great position to start things off.
That was a 44-yard return from Ezra Gray, the senior. This play is going to go for a lot less as Florida State stacks up the play. Loss of one, flag on the play. Gray was the ball carrier.
That's number 33. 15-yard penalty, first down.
Amari Gaynor's number 33 as we go down to Kelsey.
Penalties for 61 yards last week, and Coach Higgins ran the team pretty good in practice for the penalties on Sunday's practice. He said he went and talked to each guy individually, saying, we cannot do that. There are no excuses. He told us, I'm going to stay on them in practice, and I'm going to run them. And if they do it in practice, I'm going to kick them out and run them around the field, and I'll let them know from a distance why they're running. So a big emphasis this week for that team, guys.
Well, they got a negative play and turn it into a positive one. Look at this.
That's a first down and more on the pass play. Davis complete, first down, 13 yards.
And Kelsey, one thing, though, and yeah, it's a 15-yarder, and yeah, it hurts here early, but the aggressiveness, the fight, extra energy penalties, you can sometimes stand. You can't stand things like this.
And they may have got another one, James.
See, it's the execution. It's too many men on the field.
Defense number 11, Kelly Decline. It's on the play, first down.
It's not enough men on the field. It's those kinds of penalties that make you look like you're not sure what's going on as a football program. When you have an aggressive penalty, yeah, it's going to happen. Shoot, we're fired up, ready to get out there. It's unfortunate, and it's especially unfortunate now as going down deep down near the 10-yard line, Alabama State on their opening drive, aided by that big 15-yarder.
They've made 28 trips to the red zone, scored 21 times, and 20 of those have been touchdowns, and it is Gray with a loss of four. Gant made the play for the Seminoles. And no flag, luckily, on that one for Florida State. It was Alabama State, after the return by Gray in the opening kickoff of 44 yards, has the ball right near the 15-yard line of Florida State. Opening moments of the first quarter. Davis stepping forward and throwing right near the 2-yard line. And that is Michael Jefferson, the sophomore from Mobile, Alabama.
Excellent job by Davis. Had room to go run it and stopping on a dime before the line of scrimmage and threading the needle, and a great job to fight off the defender hanging on his back.
Previous play went for 13 yards. They try to run it towards the goal line and get stopped. A Garnet and Gold wall. Ezra Gray on the run. Nasrul Dean making the stop. And there was no gain on the play. And that brings a fourth down.
Offense staying out there. How big has Nasrul Dean been for this defense? 22 tackles against Boston College last week. And they will call a timeout before this fourth and very short try.
So they can get a first down without scoring with the ball at the 2-yard line and fourth and one. James, how about Alabama State right out of the gate and knocking on the door against Florida State?
You know, one thing that this Alabama State team did, Coach Donald Hill Ely was telling us beginning of the year when they went up against UAB, they made an emphasis on the start. Hey, we don't have to light the world on fire, even though they did and had some big plays and some big turnovers early. We just want to kind of get our feet wet and figure out who we are and where we are in that game without anything catastrophic happening. As we take a look at Alabama State University, a 3.5-hour bus ride up to Montgomery, Alabama. And you mentioned the 5-4 season they've had so far, doing better than expected at the beginning of the year. And now they've got their field goal unit out to try for the first points of this game.
Fighting for an Eastern Division title in the SWAC. The field goal from Hunter Hansen from 19 yards away. And the Hornets are on the board first. Electing to go for the points on fourth and one. And Hansen knocks it through. Alabama State scores on its first drive.
Hornets versus Minnesota Wild. Today at 1:30 Eastern.
ACC College Football is brought to you by Blue Cross and Blue Shield of North Carolina. Be bold, be confident, live fearless. Your local Chevy dealer, Georgia Drive Chevy. And Yellowwood brand pressure treated pine. If it doesn't have this yellow tag, you don't want it.
Inside the halls of the athletic offices at Florida State University. Here in Tallahassee, Florida, our hosts this weekend, our gracious hosts, they've rolled out the garnet carpet for us. But in this game, it's the Hornets. We get the kickoff and take the opening drive down the field and get 3 points on the board for Coach Hill Ely.
I'm sure it was tempting down that low on the road. You know, truly a nothing to lose situation, but you also want to make sure you, like they've said, let's get into this football game, not have any mistakes, just kind of weather the first 10, 15 minutes, and they absolutely did that on their opening drive offensively. 3 points to show for it.
Now they're coming off a win at Texas Southern last Saturday. This is a short kick beyond the 30-yard line, and that's where Florida State will start for its first drive. As Briggs made the fair catch. James Blackman is the starting quarterback. He's our startup, brought to you by the Honda dealers of the Carolinas for FSU, James.
And when his head coach told him that he would be the starting man going up to Boston last weekend, his eyes lit up, and his body language and his play, I think, followed. He's had a rough go at it. The offensive line hasn't given him much help at all, and it's been hard for him to be consistent and get into a rhythm. Had a chance last week, and hoping he can do that again early.
Going for a deep ball. Some space, separation to the end zone. It's Terry. 69 yards, one pass, one touchdown, FSU.
Thank you.
69 yards on the pass play, and the touchdown toss from James Blackman is 14th of the season. To Marion Terry.
How about that? In the second quarter last week on the road, had a career-high 7 catches, and one of those was a 74-yard touchdown. In the second quarter, his flags come down here. And scary Terry. That'll work.
One pass down the sideline for Blackman, who threw for 346 yards.
There was no foul to play.
And
please reset the game clock to 40, play clock to 25 seconds. Thank you.
It's a referee, Jeff McConaughey. And that drive, one play, 69 yards and 9 seconds for Florida State. Ricky Aguayo, one of the seniors honored prior to this game, for the extra point for the Noles. 8 receiving TDs for Terry. That leads the team, James Bates.
Well, nothing catastrophic. That's what Alabama State was hoping for. Not so fast. 69 yards. And on senior day, it's sophomore to sophomore. 7 points for the Noles. They're up early.
No matter when you retire, ensure you still have income every month of your retirement. Guaranteed. See how Lincoln can help.
Demarion Terry now has 5 catches of 60 yards or more this season, and that is the best in the entire country. He's trying to get warm on that sideline. It's pretty warm on that first play in the pass from Blackman, and it went for 69 yards, a drive of 9 seconds, and just one play on the TD connection.
Noles need to do a better job of covering here than they did on the opening kickoff to back it up, though.
This is Gray, and he'll allow that one to bounce in the end zone and roll on through. All right, with Florida State leading 7-3, time for our keys to the game, brought to you by your local Ford dealer with James Bates.
And how about a little tip of the cap to Burt Reynolds? A couple songs from Burt Reynolds movies. Alabama State sneaking around. That was with Dolly, by the way. Sneaking around. You got to sneak a few in, like special teams, like the big kickoff return. You know, you'd like to see him maybe even go for it down low close to the goal line, but sneaking around right there and eastbound and down. In 2 weeks, when they go east over to Gainesville to take on those Florida Gators, they want to be loaded up and trucking. They got to have a clean game today. Kelsey mentioned it. They don't want to spend the next 2 weeks working on getting on sides and getting the right number of guys out there. Illegal procedure. Clean it up a little bit so you can have some fun like this.
2 yards on the play. Ezra Gray, the runner.
Well, Nasruddin again. I mean, just from that safety spot, the 22 tackles last week against Boston College was the most by a Florida State Seminole in over 50 years. And there has been great after great after great that have come through here and won the garnet and gold on that defensive side of the ball, leading the team with over 85 now. And that's 30 more tackles than anybody else on this team.
Pressure on the quarterback. Davis has nowhere to go as the pocket collapses. Briggs Jr. first on the scene. Loss of 7 yards for the Hornets.
Well, when you mention those greats over the years for Florida State, a lot of them have come along that defensive front, and a lot of them have been so good at rushing the passer. There you see Briggs, just relentless pursuit. Corey Durden, the sophomore from Newberry, Florida, getting in there late as well. And going the wrong way right now, the Hornets, in a 3rd down and 15. And a chance for the defense to pin their ears back one more time.
4th in their conference for the Hornets on 3rd down conversions. This one's going to be well short of the marker. They needed to get to the 35-yard line. Usually convert about 39% of the time. They got 8 on the play, and there's a flag.
Eagle chop block. Offense. Number 65 and 62. Half the distance to the goal. 3rd down.
It's Williams and Kalmus on that offensive line. So that nullifies the play.
There you're going to see the left side of that line. You know, trying to take care of the safety. You can't be engaged up high and down low at the same time. And it was just for a second that... that's what you've got. So backing it up, declined rather, on a 4th down and putting it away.
Anthony Craven is the punter for Alabama State. DJ Matthews, the deep man, just inside his own 35-yard line with his team ahead 7-3. Just to get that snap away for Craven. Matthews, 32-yard line. Dances around the 40. And that's where his progress will be stopped. The punt was 40 yards. The return by Matthews was 8, and there is some post-whistle activity with 10:14 to go in the first quarter. All right, before we continue, a quick word from Advance Auto Parts.
I can sign 12 autographs in 6 seconds. So reminding you to check your battery this fast, easy.
So offensively today for Florida State, we will not see Cam Akers. He had 18 carries for 59 yards and a touchdown run last week at Boston College, but he is out with a lower body injury.
Yeah, and that's a shame. He's a guy I was looking forward to seeing. I don't think the rest of the country realizes just how good number 3 is.
Blackman, middle of the field, and it's incomplete. Maybe just a little bit behind DJ Matthews, who tried to adjust to the football. And that one fell to the turf.
Nice job by Kamar Martin, who's beat by a few steps as they try to go with the big hitter again. Only thing you can do, you can't peek, that's for sure. Put that head down and try to get there and rake through those wrists. Nice job of breaking it up after he was beat.
Blackman, far side. Incomplete, close to the 48-yard line, looking for Matthews once again. So two incompletions on first and second down. Brings up third and 10 for James Blackman and the Noles.
Well, again, back-to-back PBUs by Martin, the senior from Deerfield Beach.
Third down, bit of a struggle this season for Florida State, just 37%. That's 10th in the ACC. Blackman from a sturdy pocket. On the Alabama State side of the field is enough for a first down. Keith Gavin went up to get it. He beat Keenan Isaac. They got 15 yards, and they convert on third down for Florida State.
Wow, how about this? A good job of picking up that late blitzer in the backfield, and look at the big body. 6'3", 212, and the senior getting involved, Gavin. A nice conversion there.
Laboring on the run for 3 yards. Kalen Laboring. 5'11", 205 pounds, and a sophomore from Virginia Beach, Virginia. Ian Akers pretty much the 1-2 punch so far this season for Florida State. Again, Akers unavailable today. Lower body injury. Expected back in 2 weeks against the Gators. Blackman. Escapability. Extends the play. Makes the move at the 40. First down and more down the sideline. He stays in bounds. Blackman, they may rule him out. Back at the 22, and they will.
Wherever you want to rule him, as long as you don't rule him as a 10-yard loss, which it looked like it could have been. How about getting out of this? Houdini in the backfield and the confidence that he's been lacking so many times throughout his young career. And these throws that are being caught by his receivers and chances to tuck it and run like that, boy, that's got to feel good for the sophomore and for the Seminole Nation as well. What a big play.
He got 21 yards on that rush and that improvisation coming out of the pocket. Laboring, move it to 10. Tried to break a tackle, got inside the 5-yard line. Mark him at the 4. First and goal at 16 yards. Kalen Laboring.
A different back than number 3 in Cam Akers is Kalen Laboring. And he had that devastating knee injury early last year. The kick return against Sanford. Good to see him back out there.
That was a direct snap down to the goal line and in for the touchdown for Florida State. The snap went to Laboring. He took it into the end zone from 4 yards away. Touchdown, FSU.
Offensive coordinator Kendall Briles just dialing it up right now. The direct snap to Laboring. Fans around here getting used to that wild cam. Not the wildcat, but the direct snaps to Cam Akers have been successful quite a few times here this season. And that time it's right to the sophomore. Laboring, easy trip into the end zone.
He's got his third rushing touchdown of the season. Akers leads the way on the team with 13 rushing touchdowns. Looks like they're going to take a look at this one. Again, our referee, Jeff McConaughey. Direct snap to Labor.
Well, ruled a touchdown on the field. This may be a better look here. This is going to be right down the line. So just watch that, right knee. And that's a touchdown. Good call.
You must have indisputable video evidence to overturn the call, which on the field, James, was a touchdown. And I believe, based on the replays we've seen, it's going to stand.
I think it's indisputable evidence of a confirmation. And, you know, I mean, it's a... It was an ugly, ugly knee injury for number four last year. You watch that Virginia Tech game. It was an ugly start to the season, but there are a few of the bright spots. A couple runs by Labor. Just such a finesse, just beautiful athlete. Can really, really run. And I mean, almost Peter Warwick-like there. I know he's a receiver, but in the backfield. So hopefully he can get back to full speed.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Touchdown.
So Labor gets the rushing TD. Again, that is his third of the season. So you've got a long passing touchdown from James Blackman to Marion Terry of 69 yards. And the short rushing touchdown for the score is just 4 yards away. Labor took it in, and now the extra point for Florida State. Guayo's brother Roberto here to watch his brother be honored as one of the seniors, and it's Layburn. Took it in from 4 yards away. 14-3 FSU. Seminoles with the lead. 5-5 record on the season for Florida State. 4-4 in conference play, and they're 4-2 at home. 3-1 in conference. Here at home against ACC opponents, and one more win means a return trip to a bowl destination. They had gone 36 straight years making bowl appearances prior to last year, James, with the 5-7 record and 3-5 in conference play. Last bowl game was the 2017 Independence Bowl. Beat Southern Miss in Shreveport, Louisiana. Played in that memorable Orange Bowl as well in 2017 against Michigan. Gray's the deep man. Had that 44-yard return on the opening kickoff. But the last two have ended up in the end zone. No return from Ezra Gray.
Well, he got burned on that opening kick. A nice return by Gray, but not even giving him a chance. Kicking it out the back of the end zone. Back-to-back tries. And make them earn it a little bit. And they certainly made them earn everything the last time out. It wasn't pretty. Opening drive looked pretty good. So Davis and company need to figure out a way to just chip away. Get some positive yardage. And it was working early with the throwing game. Not so much on the ground.
Now basically all that yardage on their first possession of the game. That pass is complete. Jihad Booker, past the 30-yard line, fighting for 6 yards for Alabama State as we go down to Kelsey on the sidelines.
Yeah, you know what, Tom, you hear a lot about programs putting a big emphasis on education. Well, Alabama State head coach Hill Ely is leading by example. So he got his first degree from Virginia Union, and he said he got that degree for all the people throughout his life who told him he'd never make it to college, but that wasn't enough. Then he went and got his master's in counseling. That was for all of the people he said that would say that undergrad was the furthest he would be able to go. And then he went and got his PhD, but that, he told us, was for his players. He said with the new APR, academic progress rate for the NCAA, you really have to motivate these guys and help them understand how important school is, but he understands understands how hard it is to time manage both practice and also your schoolwork. So he said he went to battle with him. He went into trenches, got his PhD, so they would be walking across together after practice. So on both sidelines, you have two head coaches who really want to lead these teams with love and by example, guys.
Absolutely. And he said, you know, you go out in the country and you tell them you got a PhD, and they say, what is that, a post-hole digger? Absolutely not.
We should call him Dr. Donald Hill Ely.
Yes, sir.
Got that PhD at Morgan State in Baltimore, Maryland. This is third down now. Long pass play into Florida State territory, but incomplete. Looking for Booker. Devontae Taylor trying to hang with Booker. It is fourth and short for the Hornets.
They go up top. The first play from scrimmage was a good-looking play. You use the Seminole speed and aggressiveness against them. And the next two, going up top, nice coverage by Levante Taylor, the senior who was, again, back in that 2016 class, number one cornerback in the nation. So another stand here for the Seminole defense and a chance to get the ball back in the offense's hands. It's been so explosive early.
That was the first incompletion of the game for Davis, who had completed all five of his first five attempts through the air. It's going to bounce. Take a bit of a Hornet roll near the 31-yard line. That punt was 41 yards from Craven.
Well, last time out, it wasn't quite as quick as the first one. Can't beat a 69-yard touchdown pass, but it was just as pretty. James Blackman looked to be in a little bit of trouble on this Land Rover. The drive and the drive that ended into the paint, into the end zone. The direct snap to Labor to make it 14-3. And James Blackman, the sophomore from Glade Central, down in the muck. A lot of greats have come out of Glade Central, the Raiders, over the years. Gone on to play big-time football, not just in college, but the NFL.
That pass is caught. Harrison. Darius King making the stop.
Well, he shook himself up a little bit. Came over there covering so hard. There's a lot of pain, a lot of work for a two-yard gain.
You will feel the contact to the bone with these temperatures in the high 40s as Laburn got cut down by Keenan Isaac. 3 yards for Laburn, who had that 4-yard TD run.
Brought the blitzer last time. Alabama State did on third down in this situation. Couldn't get there. Ended up paying the price. Let's see what they've got right here. Go forward.
Blackman. Incomplete near the 40-yard line, looking for Harrison again. And that's now 4th and 6 with 5:33 to go in the quarter.
Kamar Martin, his third pass breakup of the day. It's been great in that Alabama State secondary. He's a Florida guy coming back to the Sunshine State and hungry early on. Forcing a three and out here on this Seminole offense.
Florida State has 6 receivers with 20 or more receptions this season, but it's 4th and 6. Crabb spun down 25-yard line. Kobe Crabb. That punt was 39 yards, and the return, 0 on the return for Crabb. How about the Hall of Famer on the sidelines? Derek Brooks, All-American linebacker, part of the 93 National Championship team. Pro Football Hall of Fame, College Football Hall of Fame, and Florida State Hall of Fame. He is our Greatness Made Here feature presented by Synovus.
One of the best to ever play the position. Love watching Derek Brooks play and compete. Not only at Florida State, but on in the NFL. And you know what? You hear it a lot, but you mean it when you say that that gentleman right there is an even better person off of the field. He's done so much for his community back in Tampa, Florida. And what an outstanding football player and off of the field as well.
And a Super Bowl champ with the Bucks as well. Duran Bell. Sophomore from Tampa, Florida. 4 yards on the carry. He's a transfer from USF. And that 4-yard carry, the longest run of the game so far. right into the arms of True Thompson. 6 feet, 315 pounds, the freshman on the defensive line for the Noles.
Well, and they need that. Alabama State needs to, they cannot go away from the run game, even though they've been stuffed in a big way early on. Florida State has to fear that they'll come back to it just to keep them honest and to get some positive yardage finally on the ground game is big for the Hornets.
Davis complete near the first down marker. They might have just enough to Farmer. Going to be a little bit short on the spot there, James. They needed to get to the 36. That ball is just beyond the 35 of the Hornets.
What a tough spot, isn't it? They had the third and short early down near the goal line when they went for the field goal. Seminoles walked up an aggressive looking pre-snap anyway.
0 for 3 on third down. Looks like they're going to be 0 for 4 as Bell. Very close again. Now the spot's much better here, and that's the first down.
Well, Duran Bell.
Second effort.
Yeah, Duran Bell. It was a hard-fought 1 yard right there. That second effort as he just rolls over. He's smacked in the backfield and able to just kind of roll his way and fight for the first down to stay alive and get those chains moving. Back in the opener against UAB, he had some fireworks, a big explosive play, 67-yard touchdown run in the first quarter, ensuing kickoff. The Hornets forced a fumble and scored on the next play through the air. So Bell and Gray, the two backs that have been the mainstays in the backfield for Hill Ely and the Hornets.
So we thought they got the necessary yard, and they have, and now they've called a timeout with 3:35 to go. This is the second FBS opponent. James, you mentioned UAB. By the way, there's also a flag on the play, too. This is the first time, though, that this program has played a team from the Atlantic Coast Conference. Last year, they played at Auburn and lost 63-9. So they have dabbled against Power 5 FBS opponents. Prior to 2018, you have to go back to 2013 when they lost at Kentucky, 48-14. So with 3:35 to go in the first quarter, it's a 14-3 lead for Florida State. Coach Odell Hagans, 3-0 as an interim head coach. Had to do the same thing back in 2017 and won the last two games. And the emotion of senior day, James, and everything that has happened to these young men over the course of the last 4 to 5 years. Change in coaching staffs. And today, though, culminating with a hug from their head coach, Odell Hagans.
Yeah, man. They've been through a lot. And, you know, it says a lot about those young men that they've stuck it out, that they've stayed right here in Tallahassee. You see guys jumping around so much now this day and age.
Pass by Davis is incomplete. That on first down to Booker. It seems as though Florida State, when Coach Hagans takes over, as I told you, he had a couple of games as the interim head coach. Joe Blackwell, the first-year offensive coordinator, who's been at Norfolk State and South Carolina State as well. He's a native of Greenville, South Carolina, trying to figure out this Florida State defense. But the teams respond. Florida State's averaged 41 points in the wins for Coach Hagans, and they've got 14 here in the first quarter, deep into this first quarter. Left side, there's some daylight on an overcast day for Ezra Gray. His name kind of matches the skies today, really thick cloud cover here in Tallahassee, and he got 8 yards.
Nice looking run there, set him up in a third down and short against Texas Southern. Gray went for 154 yards rushing.
James, you're right.
It was an offense that had zero passing yards in the second half, so they certainly needed him in the win last time out.
Won at 27-21 in Houston, Texas, against Texas Southern. That's the Booker at a first down. Bolden made the play defensively for the Noles, but they got 9 yards, and that'll grease the chains and move them.
Nice. nice throw and a great catch out route there on a third down in short. And how about that? 15, the sophomore transfer from Memphis. Hometown kid back to Montgomery, Alabama, where he went to high school. Look at that. Extends, looks it in, and able to hang on with that one hand. And Alabama State putting together a nice little drive here.
From the 47 of Florida State, Davis has to find another option and does. Inside the 45-yard line, again, it's Booker, a popular target. Stanford Samuels the third on the coverage for the Noles.
Well, Davis, with a lot of bodies coming, they do a good job of buying him some time up front, that offensive line, and using his feet to get a couple extra steps and a chance for Booker to get open. And on first down, a nice pickup of five. Hornets feeling it a little bit. Look at him, clapping it up along that offensive front. Kind of weathering the storm, if you will, early.
Third catch for Booker. That last one went for 5 yards. And from the 42, the handoff, Ezra Gray. Back to the original line of scrimmage. Amari Gaynor, part of the tackling group for Florida State. Gray trots to the sidelines. It was 154 yards last week against Texas Southern, a career high for Ezra Gray on 24 carries. And his numbers for the season, a couple of TD rushes. And he had that big kickoff return to start the game of 44 yards as well.
It was a Bama State team that was hot in the first half and let Texas Southern back into it with the turnovers. Holding on to that football so far here today.
Third and five, 1 for 4 on third down. This is Bell. He's got it. Kept his footing. Duran Bell on third down for Alabama State. And they got 20 yards on the play. First down.
Again, a nice play call here. Here's the all 22 look. And just watch him swing outside. All those bodies out into the flat. No one left to cover. And an outstanding catch by Bell. We've seen a couple good catches by the receivers in the backs on this drive by Alabama State, and another first down.
Davis, quick toss, knocked in the air and deflected it incomplete. On the first down play with now just 23 seconds to go in the quarter, Akeem Dent back there for the Noles. Michael Jefferson was the intended receiver.
Boy.
Well, Dent knocked it in the air off of his shoulder pad.
Hornet fans holding their breaths as it seemed to hang up there forever. Thought maybe a Seminole might come down with it. We'll live to play another play here with 23 left in the first quarter.
Line of 12 and 92 yards for Davis. So he's going to add to that total as well into the red zone. Jimmy Farrell making the catch. 3 yards on the play, and the clock continues to roll. Two for five on third down, but we'll have to wait till the start of the second quarter for this third down play. Into the red zone for Coach Hill Ely and the visiting Hornets on senior day for the Seminoles. One quarter done. Here in Tallahassee, 14-3, FSU in front of Alabama State.
You don't want it.
In the CPI security red zone for Alabama State as we start the second quarter.
Now the quick game has worked a little bit here for Alabama State when they've had the blitz on, getting that ball out of the hands real quick. The offense, Kadarius Davis and company for Donald Hill Ely. That time it's run down in a hurry.
So Hunter Hansen, who hit a field goal in the first quarter of 19 yards, will try a 38-yard attempt. Hansen, 6 of 8 on field goal attempts this year. And that is no good.
So the 38-yarder from Hanson outside of the pipe. And that drive that started on the 26-yard line. It was a 13-play drive, but they were unable to get any points out of it, James. A review of the first quarter, just 3 rushing yards for Alabama State, but trying to hang in there with Florida State 14-3.
Yeah, look at that difference in time of possession, just 3:17. The Kendall Briles offense, a 69-yard touchdown pass to Terry from Blackman to start the scoring. And rushing yards, just 3 on 10 carries for Alabama State offensively. And there you go. We've got Jordan Travis in there.
So Travis in at quarterback. Tries a stiff arm, turning the corner, flag is out. He's up past the 30-yard line, but a flag came out on the run. Joshua Hill forced him out. And there's Jordan Travis.
Back, offense, number 89, 10-yard penalty, first down.
That's on Keith Gavin, senior for Florida State. That'll nullify the run from Travis.
Right there, bottom of your screen, and, you know, a better job than Boston College did, the 3 carries by this young man, the transfer from Louisville, Jordan Travis. He had 3 carries, 94 yards, the 66-yard touchdown run that we showed you off the top of the show, the longest run by a Florida State quarterback ever. And it's 1-and-done as James Blackman comes back in.
So Travis, on his first career snap against the Eagles, went 26 yards for a touchdown in the third quarter. This is into double coverage, past the 50. Flag is out on the Blackman pass.
Defense number 94, 5-yard penalty, first down.
Jeff McGonaghy has the call. It goes against Alabama State and number 94, Christian Clark.
Right there in the middle of your screen, too early, and a good job by Johnson. Get that snap and the free play. Toss it up there and nothing doing.
Clark was swag. First team selection a season ago. Penalty went against him. That pass to Gavin. Davis on the tackle. For the Hornets, there's a flag on the play.
He grabbed the face mask there. As he brought him down is what it looked like from up here. I don't think they had any penalties in the first half, Alabama State.
Personal foul, face mask. Defense number 22, 15-yard penalty, first down.
And that's the call, in position to go make the play. And grabs, you get, just continues to just pull down. Ershad Davis, the freshman, former Carroll City Chief in high school. Another great program down in South Florida.
First and 10 for the Noles from the 46. This is Blackman. Runs out of the pocket. And they run him down. Ogletree makes the play on Blackman. The first sack of the game for the Hornets. There's a loss of 2 on the play. There is an Alabama State player down.
That's the middle linebacker that means so much to this defense. Bubba Adams, leading tackler the last 2 years. Hope he's okay.
On Fox Sports South.
Well, welcome back. 14-3 Seminoles. Here's a look at that last play. Colton Adams, the middle linebacker. And now he's hurt. It came in awkwardly on that right leg. He's missed the first 5 games of this season after being the leading tackler the last 2 years, leading the team in tackles for loss. Just an awkward plant. Hopefully he's okay, and hopefully he didn't damage that beautiful mullet that the coaches were telling us about. I'd like to see him take that hat off and show it off a little bit.
So Darren Johnson has come in for Colton Bubba Adams, who is a freshman on this Alabama State team this year. Second and 12 for Blackman. Terry can't quite get to midfield. Committee tackle by Alabama State. and 3 yards for Tamarian Terry, who has a 69-yard touchdown reception on the first offensive play of the game for Florida State.
You know, it's good to see James Blackman continue on from the success they had last week and stay in a little bit of a rhythm. And not just with these underneath throws here a little bit, but the deep ball as well.
That's complete to Young. He gets to the 40.
There's a chance for the Alabama State defense to get off the field. Short pass. Jordan Young, a redshirt freshman, has to make one guy miss. He does that, and it's off to the races. Move those sticks. Fresh set of downs. Nice play.
Just the second catch of the season for Young. This inside the 10. It's Harrison to the goal line and in. Touchdown, Florida State of 39 yards.
We talk about the rhythm and we talk about the throws, and this one has to be right there on the spot, right in the middle of that zone coverage, and that's a beautifully thrown football. We've seen the deep one, the one to Terry to start the game, and it's a nice flow right now for the sophomore quarterback, James Blackman. Outstanding pass right there, and good job by the youngster Harrison to get it into the paint afterwards.
39 yards, Blackman to Harrison. Second TD pass of the game for Blackman. Treshawn Harrison with the touchdown catch, his second of the season.
Follow their story at futureofhere.com. Synovus, the bank of here.
Couple of TD passes in the game for James Blackman. He's now got 15 touchdown passes for the season. Our five-star drive summary brought to you by Yellowwood. Six plays, 79 yards to Harrison for 39 yards. And the lead for Florida State, 21-3. It has been a turbulent few weeks for this program. A loss against Miami, the dismissal of Willie Taggart. Odell Hagans taking over as interim head coach for the second time. But it is steady as she goes so far today against the Hornets from Alabama State as the kickoff goes out of bounds. All-American defensive lineman in his days as a Knoll in uniform from 85 to 89. And he's been an assistant here since 1994. Second longest tenured assistant in college football.
And a captain for 3 years as a Florida State Seminole for Bobby Bowden. 3 years. How about that? As a sophomore, junior, and senior. You know, you notice that C on the chest of James Blackman, his quarterback, as well, a young leader on the team he's coaching there. Play that worked earlier, snuffed out in a hurry this time. Good job defensively by Harlan Barnett's secondary. They got about five or six on it last time. This time they didn't go flying out of there, so it's shut down quickly.
Just 2 yards on the previous play for the Hornets. Second and 8. Hornets are working on a 2-game winning streak as that pass falls incomplete from Davis.
There's a late flag here, and it's going to be on Litton. He was obstructing Michael Jefferson, the leading receiver, trying to get to that ball, and just walling him off and let him make the cut. Nice job protecting.
Pass interference defense. The ball be placed in the spot of the foul. First down.
And you see, there's Litton circled. And he just wraps him up. That's one way to keep him from going in there. The sophomore A.J. Litton. Yep, not legal.
2 wins in a row for the Hornets. First back-to-back win since 2017. As we told you, they're still alive in the SWAC in the Eastern Division. After beating Texas Southern a week ago. That's up near midfield. I believe Michael Jefferson. He had a big game against Texas Southern James. Five catches, 102 yards, and three touchdown receptions for Jefferson against Texas Southern in a winning effort.
You know, we've talked up on the other side, James Blackman, quite a bit, but Kadarius Davis has done a great job standing in there. The offensive line has done a good job of chopping down the guys up front for Florida State and the good quick game and being on target. Davis has done good so far.
Yeah, he's 13 of 16 through the air. This is Bell with 10 and a half minutes to go in the quarter and 3 yards. Nasruddin on the stop, the junior from Concord, North Carolina. And he's slow to get up as well. So we'll take a timeout. Third down, straight ahead. 21-3 Noles. Second quarter, Bobby Bowden Field at Doak Campbell Stadium, home of the Noles, and leading 21-3 in their final home game of the season, a victory today, and they are bowl eligible. Incredible tradition here in Tallahassee, three-time national champs, 93, 99, and 2013, the final year of the BCS. One in the Rose Bowl against Auburn, 34-31. Bell on the carry for the Hornets, and that's a first down.
Well, and that's a good job. Twice here early, we've seen a third down and one, and Alabama State able to find a way to just get enough, one or two, to move those chains. It's a defensive front. It's as big as you're going to find in college football. They've got to own those situations. This is a SWAC team coming in here. They need to step up, like Coach Hagen said last week at halftime to the team. It's time to become men. It's instances like that where it would show.
Up the middle with Bell in a short gain. James, they've got their own tradition as well for the Hornets. Program started in 1901. 501 all-time wins for the program. They got number 500 November 2nd at Mississippi Valley State. Beat them 27-0 to hit that benchmark. They've had a wild season, James. How about the Magic City Classic?
How many overtimes was that one?
Three overtimes, and they lost to Alabama A&M 43-41. They failed on their two-point conversion in the third overtime in front of 53,000 fans at Legion Field in Birmingham, Alabama.
Is that all you got? We had our six overtime.
Really? You know, we're the only ones that can say that.
Right.
First implementation of the new rules, of course. Once you get to the fifth overtime, it's just two-point conversions. And from the third overtime on, you must go for two after a touchdown. So they went to three overtimes with Alabama A&M and came up just short. Jordan Bentley ran for 197 yards for Alabama A&M in the winning effort.
Such a big game for them, too. Would have been a huge win, and would have been a nice play there. Michael Jefferson, unable to get a foot down, caught the ball, but he was out of bounds. So here's a situation you don't want to find yourself in. Kadarius Davis and the offense, a third down and long. They need seven. Noles are walked up right now. Everybody is coming here.
Quick release. Davis. Pass appeared to be on target, but knocked away. Michael Jefferson, the receiver. Bolden, the defender. And now fourth down, James.
Well, Isaiah Bolden, one of the many youngsters here on this team. A lot of promising talent there on the field, and a good job there. Man-to-man comes right across and rips it away. Perfectly defended. As they had the blitz on.
So now in fourth and seven with the ball at the 42. They're kind of in between as far as field goal and punt are concerned. So they're going to go for it. 5 of 14 on fourth down of the season. This is fourth and seven for Davis. Throws it inside the 25. And the catch is made. Circus grab, Michael Jefferson. First down, Hornets at 21 yards.
How about this throw and catch going for it on fourth down? That's what we're talking about. Sneaking around. Watch the underneath coverage of Taylor. He's got to put some air underneath it, but he's got to be careful. Only one spot he can throw it, or it's an interception by Dent. And going up in traffic, Michael Jefferson sacrificing his body and concentrating, watching it in. The leading receiver who had five catches, three of those touchdown receptions in the win over Texas Southern last week.
He's got four catches for 50 yards today in that clutch fourth down conversion. Duran Bell for a yard. Gainer on the tackle, Florida State. Alabama State, it is 21-3, James, but they have acquitted themselves quite well coming out of the SWAC and the football championship subdivision today against Florida State.
I agree, absolutely. And I've really been impressed with the start right there with number 12. Slinging it around a little bit behind an offensive line that's given him just enough time in this quick game.
Davis has been very accurate today. This pass is caught at about the 17-yard line. Farrell, 6 yards. And that's his third grab.
And not afraid as they go into the CPI security red zone here. But that's one thing with Davis. He's quick on the trigger, and he's not afraid to pull it. And part of the reason that he has 11 interceptions, but it hasn't been the case here so far. I mean, he's made up his mind in a hurry and just quick on the draw, distributing the ball around. And here's a third down and short now.
And he tried to get it on the ground, and they won't. It's Bell who got knocked to the turf. Nasrul Dean, good to see him back at full capacity after he was slow to get up a few plays ago.
Unless you're Bell, if you're Duran Bell, it's not good to see him back.
Good point.
Wow. Just feeling in a hurry. He's not coming from his linebacker spot. He's coming that quick from his safety spot and just dropping in there in a hurry. 22 tackles against BC. One more try.
So this will be a 35-yarder, James. Anthony Craven on the hold. Hunter Hansen is one for two. From 35 yards away for Hansen. And that one is right down Broadway. So a 35-yarder.
Bop, that.
And a 19-yarder. And the miss from 38 also in this quarter. 21-6. Second field goal of the game for Hunter Hansen. Coach Bill Ely.
Those are the Hansons.
The ACC football doubleheader kicks off at noon on Fox Sports South. Brought to you by your local Ford dealer.
ACC College Football is brought to you by CPI Security.
Haskins Circus Complex. Performers training here on the Tallahassee campus of Florida State. Looks like our director, Lonnie Dale, up there on the trapeze. Hang on tight, Lonnie. He always works without a net, though, so it couldn't have been him. How about that? A little study discipline of circusology.
Absolutely, and they've had some acrobatic players on the football field over the years. There's one of them right there, the sophomore quarterback, James Blackman. There was actually a Barnum and Bailey Training Center circus headquarters down in Sarasota, I believe, not too long ago, but it's a different level here at Florida State University. I think it was Eric Kendall, our producer, doing the double dutch right at the first shot.
5:48 to go in the second. Blackman in at quarterback for Florida State. We did see Jordan Travis, but for only one play that was nullified by a penalty marker. Up the middle on the run from Sheffield. And let's check in with Kelsey. She's got more on Bubba Adams.
Yeah, he was getting his right ankle looked at. He's able to walk on it fine, but he went to try to run. And right when he started, he turned around, looked at his training staff, and shook his head and said no. And he actually went back into the Florida State tunnel, maybe working with their medical staff as well, guys. He was able to walk off on his own power.
Yeah, we saw Darren Johnson, number 46, who was in for Adams. But he's certainly an important part of that defensive unit for Alabama State. And their defensive coordinator, Travis Pearson, in his second year. Third and one. 2 for 3 on third down of the game. Knowles. The Hornet defense may have denied the Knowles. In fact, there's no gain on the play and short of the 35-yard line. That was the line to gain.
And Sheffield. Layburn's back up. If you joined us late, Cam Akers unable to go today, and the coaches told us if it were Florida they were playing, he wouldn't be able to go. So hoping he can be healthy. And Sheffield, the walk-on running back, stuffed at the line.
This is Martin to punt. When you're talking about Akers, that's a guy who's run for over 2,700 career yards, sixth in school history, but unavailable today. A fair catch is made. Kobe Crabb, just over 4 seconds of hang time and 31 yards on the punt from number 30, Tommy Martin, the sophomore from Chesapeake, Virginia.
Well, still plenty of time here for Kadarius Davis in this offense to put together another drive. They've been able to move the football, just 6 points to show for it. There's a look at Cam Akers.
And while we see Cam Akers, we have the Aflac Duck in the Aflac Trivia Quiz. Mississippi native Cam Akers. There's the total yards. What college running back from Mississippi has the most all-time for a Power 5 school? Chew on that, James Bates. It's the Aflac Trivia Quiz. That'll be ruled a pass to Allen.
So
2 yards.
A Power 5 school since they've been called Power 5 schools?
We'll have to go to the judging panel for further.
You know, while you're thinking about this one, I got one for you. Cam Akers may not be the most famous graduate to come out of his high school back in Clinton, Mississippi. Clinton High School. You know who it is?
You want to wait and we'll do like a double answer on the Aflac trivia quiz?
Yeah, double Aflac.
All right,
double
down. Here's Davis. Wow, what a pass in between two defenders. Michael Jefferson. That is a lethal combination. 17 yards. Davis to Jefferson.
Kadarius Davis has really been stealing the show here, distributing the football. A nice route. Beautifully thrown football again. Again, such a tight hole to throw it into. And right there for Jefferson. Catch it and put a foot down before he goes out of bounds. They will take a look at it.
Now, if it stands, it's 5 catches for 67 yards for Jefferson from Davis. There is an official review ongoing.
Here's another look. And how about this ball? One more chance to talk him up. If the foot is down. Does he have control there? Yes.
How about the location of the pass, the catch radius? It's all there, James, it appears.
Look at Jefferson, 6'3", 188 pounder, 10 touchdown receptions on the year.
And he found some space between Nasruddin and Samuels, and the play is confirmed.
That's working.
We saw that excellent replay from our production crew, led by producer Eric Kendall, director Ronnie Dale, technical director Michael Thompson, and our outstanding group of women and men who work so hard each and every Saturday to bring you ACC college football. We salute them. We're nearing the end of our season, James. Just a couple more games to go after this one. We'll be at North Carolina next week as they take on Mercer.
Look at those numbers, 17 of 22. They're 144 already against the Florida State secondary. That's going nowhere fast. Great job to knife through there. Amari Gaynor has been so active here early. Redshirt freshman linebacker. Pretty easy on him, knowing there to block him. 33 and 23 all over the field here early on.
How about just
for the tackles?
Just 7 total rush yards in the game so far for Alabama State against Florida State.
But again, just to keep them home, they've got to keep coming back to it. We saw a couple plays ago, the 4-yard gain. They've had some success on the third and shorts. But most of the success, as you're saying, has come from the ball in the air.
58% of the season for Davis, and he went for the long ball and just a little bit too far. Tariq Allen was the receiver. Akeem Dent trying to go stride for stride with Allen, the senior from San Antonio, Texas.
Well, and he had him off the mark a little bit here with this ball by Davis. He's thrown so many pretty ones, he'd love to have that one back. And Allen, the senior from San Antonio, Texas, was the leading receiver on this Hornet team last year. Boy, what a big play that would have been. So instead, it's third down and 14. You better be careful. Let's see what Harlan Barnett and this defense dials up here and what could be big blitz down.
The 6 points for the Hornets from field goals from Hunter Hansen. One in the first quarter, one in the second, and a timeout taken.
Alabama State.
By Alabama State. And they have exhausted their complement of timeouts for the first half. That means they're out of timeouts, James. Sorry. Just clarifying.
I appreciate it.
There's the conversation. Head coach Donald Hill Ely. Dr. Donald Hill Ely. And the offensive coordinator Joe Blackwell in his first season. Alabama State dominating time of possession as well.
Look at Akers, the former quarterback in high school, Clinton, Mississippi.
Are you ready to answer these questions?
All right, here you go. All right. I wouldn't have gotten this one. Anthony Dixon.
Right, exactly.
Mississippi State.
There you go. That's okay. The tie-in with Cam Akers. And what about, well, here you go. Here's the list. 2,772 yards.
Robert Gillespie, who is now down there number 7, the running back at Florida, is now the running back coach for Mack Brown at North Carolina. Dizzy Gillespie. And look at Clinton Portis. Wait a minute. No. Clinton Portis went to Gainesville High School. Maybe he grew up in Mississippi.
Back to pass is Davis over the middle.
Wow.
Inside the 25 and caught. Booker, and he got hit by Dent and hung on to the football.
These Hornets are not scared to go up in traffic and get this football, fighting for it. And the quarterback that's putting it up there for him, knowing he's going to take a hit, the sophomore Jahad Booker, with a great big catch on third down and long.
And that was 27 yards, Davis to Booker, and his fifth catch. That one's too high. Out in the flat to Allen. He'll stop the clock. 1:40 to go in the quarter.
All right, Tom, real quick. You want the answer to mine before we get too far away?
Yeah, go ahead.
The answer is not Ted DiBiase, the WWF wrestler, pro wrestling star, even though he went to Clinton High School there in Mississippi. It is Lance Bass from NSYNC. How about that?
So we had the Hanson brothers a moment ago. Yeah. Now we got Lance Bass from
NSYNC. Covering them all.
See if Florida State can cover all the receivers from Alabama State here on this 2nd and 10 play, because Davis has been on target so far in this game.
Getting the clarification, Laurel, Mississippi is where Portis grew up, but he ended up going to the same high school as Tom Petty in Gainesville, Florida. And here's a whistle before they can get this one off. Call timeout.
Yeah, Davis is 18 of 24 through the air. All right. I just told you that a second ago, James.
That they were exhausted.
Well, they may be exhausted also, and chilly. But they don't have any timeouts to utilize. ...171 yards through the air in the first half for Davis. The head coach, Donald Hill Ely, third season. Spinning maneuver, Ezra Gray. All that effort, no gain.
All show, no go. It looked pretty, but until you run into that wall of garnet and gold just waiting on him, not much there. So here's a third down and 15 again. Here late in this first half, Alabama State Hornets. Coach Hill Ely just trying to figure out a way to get a few more points, going to that halftime locker room, chip into that lead a little bit.
Minute to go. Davis throws down near the 5. Booker reaching out but couldn't get there. Bolden was with him defensively. So now it's fourth down.
And that
field goal unit, Hanson and company out there one more time. This one's going to take a little bit more leg, though.
So he is 2 for 3 so far with makes from 19 and 35 yards. This is a 45-yarder. His career long is 48 yards. As long as 43 this season, that was against Tuskegee. This from 45 yards away, and that's going to be well to the left. So the 45-yarder is no good late in this second quarter with 52 seconds to go. So he's 2 for 4.
That's our cameraman, Tigger. Boy, he got a standing ovation.
He caught it on the fly operating the camera? Did he make a one-handed grab back there?
No. Oh, but he went up and high-pointed the football like I've never seen a cameraman do before. Here, watch it. See if you can see the cheerleaders cheering for him as soon as he catches it, too. This has been a highlight of the game. Watch it. Look at them all. He tucks it away.
What about the awareness?
I know.
To abandon the camera and catch the football.
And we get to show off that scarf. That's pretty.
Miss from 45 yards away. Blackman inside of a minute to play. His pass near the 40-yard line. And it's incomplete. Cameron McDonald was number 87 for the Noles. And coming up at halftime, we'll discuss that FSU coaching situation. Some of the candidates, perhaps you're looking at a very qualified candidate, a longtime assistant, Odell Hagans, who took over after the loss against Miami. Second time he's had to do that. Had to do it in 2017, and they've won every game with him as the interim head coach. And that includes last week at Boston College, who's 3-0, or as a lot of people have been saying, 3-Odell. There's a player down, James, for the Hornets.
Yeah, Florida State lucky it's not James Blackman. He took a big hit, twisting in there. And that's one thing that as you go on, just a sophomore, James Blackman, you'd like to see in this offseason put a little bit of meat on those bones, a little bit more weight. There's the hit. He's slippery, though, and it's hard to get a tough shot on him, even when you've got him wrapped up a little bit. You know, looking forward to breaking down a little bit, just some of the thoughts on that coaching search here at Florida State, but also looking forward to seeing the Alabama State Band. We'll have a chance to check out the Marching Hornets.
Cameron Rampersad is the player down for Alabama State. Coach Hagans coached the last two games of the 2017 season, and that was a win against ULM 42-10 at home, and then a win in the Independence Bowl against Southern Miss 42-14. So we've been here before. And all he wanted to do yesterday in our meetings was talk about the devotion and dedication of these young men whom he honors. And he said, I love them all, from walk-on to star player. And complete support for this group that has been through quite a bit over the last few years. And good to see Rampersad. With some assistance from the training and medical staff, the senior.
Yeah, but that's right there in the middle of that Alabama State defense. And not just for today, but already getting Bubba Adams banged up. There's Rampersad going to the locker room. They've got a big one against Prairie View A&M on Thanksgiving Day. So,
yeah, they call that one the Turkey Day Classic, James. 96th edition against Prairie View A&M. The opponents change ever so often, but they'll play on Thanksgiving Day for the 96th time.
Well, be careful here defensively, Hornets. Don't give up a big explosive right before halftime. Let them run by it like the first play from scrimmage.
Blackman, poise in the pocket, delivers the football near the 40-yard line. It's Marion Terry who gets wrestled to the turf, 13 yards on the play.
And it was Terry on that first play of the game offensively for the Seminoles. It took it 69 yards to the house.
And how about the concentration there? He went down, had to put a hand down on the turf. Ball was waiting on him when he brought his eyes up, still able to bring it in.
Three catches, 85 yards for Terry. This is a deep ball, too far for receiver and defender near the 20-yard line of the Hornets. DJ Matthews was back there for Florida State. Terry, the leading receiver for this team coming into the game with 40. He's now got 43 for the season, and that was incomplete to Matthews.
Well, and that touchdown, actually, Tom, to start it, he's got four touchdowns in his career over 70 yards. That one was 1 yard below it at 69. But Scary Terry, nonetheless, continues to make big play after big play for this Seminole offense.
Yeah, over 800 total yards receiving this season, third in the ACC for Tamarian Terry. He's got 85 yards in this game. Blackman throws it down the line to Young, who's near midfield. That's short of the marker, 9 yards on the play. There's only a few seconds to go in the quarter. And a timeout taken by FSU. 9 seconds to go, a 21-6 lead. Two TD passes from Blackman and a TD rush from Kalen Laburn in the first quarter of 4 yards. Third rushing TD of the season for Laburn.
Yeah, so no Cam Akers today for Florida State. Darius Washington, a freshman left tackle, is out. Has only played in 4 games, so he will redshirt, a true freshman. Trey McKitty, the tight end, played hurt on that bad ankle at Boston College last weekend and unavailable to go today for his offensive coordinator, Kendall Bryles. But James Blackman, who had a solid game against those Boston College Eagles in the big upset win on the road. And Odell Hagan's first trip as an interim head coach in 2019. Back, we're on the show here today.
TD passes of 74 and 60 yards against the Eagles as that one sails over the middle and incomplete to Jordan Young. Blackman helped up after the hit, 4 seconds to go, and it's fourth down.
Listen. Body's falling, and you know what? That's a good no call as a defensive back breaking on the ball for Alabama State. And Florida State wide receiver just running into him as he's going for the ball as well.
So with just 4 seconds to go in fourth and one, Florida State leads the offense out there. 7 of 14 on fourth down this season for the Seminoles. And what should be the last play of the half. There's a lateral on the play. Okay, getting crafty. Tamarian Terry made the catch, lateral to Harrison. But he got tackled. They got 6 yards. It all adds up to the end of the first half. So the Noles, in their final home game, will go to the locker room with a 21-6 lead on the strength of two TD passes from Blackman and a TD run from Laburn. A couple of field goals for ASU, Alabama State University, from Montgomery, Alabama. As we go down to Kelsey.
Thank you so much. Done here with Coach Hagans now. And Coach, you guys held Alabama State to 6 points. You held them to 7 yards rushing. Did you like the way that your team played in the first half?
Well, the penalties, that's what I don't like. And making mistakes. And also, we're not out there playing fundamentally sound. That's something we're going to correct in the locker room. But, hey, it is. And I told the kids, I say, opponents are faceless. You got to play hard every week.
James Blackman had a big run. He has a touchdown pass. He's moving the ball. What growth have you seen from him just in the past few weeks?
Well, James Blackman, he's becoming a playmaker. And the thing about it, you tell him, Blackman is not there running. He's doing exactly what Coach Bryles wanted him to do.
Thank you so much for your time, Coach. Good luck in the second half. Guys, we'll get it back up to you. Thank you.
Kelsey, thank you. The always gracious and thoughtful Odell Hagans. And when we come back, the Marching Hornets. We'll be on the field later on at halftime. We'll talk about that coaching situation here at Florida State. The Noles have the halftime lead over the visiting Hornets, 21-6. Please stay with us for halftime coming up after this quick break.
Our Florida State University.
Welcome back into halftime. halftime, Florida State leads Alabama State 21-6. And Alabama State in the SWAC, when a lot of people think of the SWAC, you think of the incredible halftime performances. So you're in for a treat today, guys. Sit back, relax, grab some popcorn, and take a listen to the mighty Marching Hornets.
ACC College Football is brought to you by your local Ford dealer. The Works Tryvac, now 10% off. Order now. And Z-Max Micro Lubricant, available at AutoZone.
Odell Haggins, the interim head coach and one of the All-Americans on that wall of fame here at Doak Campbell Stadium. And his team has a 21-6 lead at halftime over the visiting Alabama State Hornets. Now, at the beginning of the month, November 2nd, it was a loss at home against Miami and the subsequent dismissal of Willie Taggart. The search is on. James, Florida State has said they would like to wrap it up, name a new coach by the end of the month. We've talked about Coach Haggins. There are several other candidates in the mix, but it is a situation where they need to make a determination relatively soon, and they want to return this program to the glory that it once recognized and realized here in Tallahassee.
Well, they'd like to make it soon, but one thing's for sure, they can't miss this time around. Florida State University, they have to bring in the right man to head this football program. And some of the names that have been thrown out there as you take a look, and many of them, you know, they had their hopes set on Bob Stoops, and just he has removed his name from the mix. That's no longer a candidate, and the top five candidates according to NoGameDay.com. And you know, you can go across the board. There are so many different names out there, but these are a few names that keep coming up. Matt Campbell at Iowa State has done a fantastic job. Mike Norvell, following in the footsteps of Justin Fuente, who did a great job there and then went on to be the head coach at Virginia Tech, a team that is still in the mix on the coastal side in the ACC after stumbling out the gate. But how about Brent Venables? Would Brent Venables want to leave that what seems to be a perfect situation for probably
the best defensive coordinator in college football right now. And you think about it. Brent Venables has coached under Bob Stoops. He's coached under Dabo Sweeney, who, by the way, was an interim head coach himself. And there's one right there in Odell Haggins. The one thing that is really tough for Odell Haggins is I hate that he has to go to the locker room, and the first thing he says to Kelsey is he has to mention those penalties and just the sloppiness. That's the sloppiness. It's a residual, let's face it, of what's really kind of gone on here the last couple seasons. And they've got to flush that out of their systems. They're going to win this football game here today, probably. But for them to beat Florida in a couple weeks in Gainesville and to give him a chance, think about it. They go in there and they beat the Florida Gators. They weren't supposed to beat Boston College. No one's going to give him a chance to beat Florida. If they do that, I don't know how that can't be one of your top candidates and give him as good a chance as anybody. And it has the same feeling. Even though Ed Orgeron had a lot of head coaching experience and it wasn't always pretty before he became the guy at LSU, it has that same feeling like he's one of us. He's truly one of us. And it doesn't get any more Seminole than this guy right here, Odell Haggins. But first things first, they have got to clean up some of the sloppiness.
An All-American player and an assistant here at Florida State since 1994. To Marion Terry with that 69-yard touchdown on the very first play for the Seminoles on offense. They've got the 21-6 lead.
Carolina Hurricanes versus Minnesota Wild. Today at 1:30 Eastern.
The Noles just a half away from being bowl eligible and getting their sixth win of the season. The second half is straight ahead. They'll get the ball to start it, leading 21-6 against the Hornets. Just about set to start the third quarter before we do. Down to Kelsey Wingert, standing by with Donald Hill Ely, the head coach of Alabama State, just moments ago.
Thank you guys so much. Down here with Coach Hill Ely right now. And Coach, first half, how would you evaluate what your team was able to do versus a really good Florida State defense?
Well, you know what? I like the energy that the guys are playing with. You know, we left a lot of points out there. We just got to finish drives offensively. We had two blown coverages where they scored on our defense. So just continue to play and keep composure.
Thank you so much for your time. Good luck in the second half, Coach.
All right, Kelsey. He talked about those two blown coverages, and you look at the passing yards for Florida State, 182, and a good chunk of those made up of the 69-yarder, of course, to start the game, the touchdown by Terry. How about the time of possession? Over 22 minutes, the Hornets held the football, and just under 8 for the Seminoles, but with the lead 21-6, and Florida State's going to get the ball to start the second half here.
First ever meeting between the programs. It's a short kick fielded near the 25-yard line. Jaleel McCray, number 42.
Well, big plays for the offense. Picking up where they left off. Some big ones up on Chestnut Hill last weekend in the win over BC. Terry to get things started from Blackman, and then Blackman doing it all himself. Almost dropped for a big loss on the sack, but wasn't having it. And then this beautifully thrown football to Harrison, the sophomore from Seattle, later in the first half. So the sophomore from Glade Central, former Raider in high school, back out there to get things going, start the third quarter.
He was 11 of 17 through the air, 182 yards and a couple of TDs. And the 69-yarder to Terry. Laburn will run it up near the 30-yard line and get 5. Florida State 4-2 at home this season, 3-1 in conference play. And that win that James mentioned on the road at Boston College, 38-31 last Saturday. When James, I would venture to guess, not a lot of people in the building or on the national scene thought that Florida State could pull it off, and they defeated the Eagles, rolling up over 500 yards of total offense.
Wow, what a big win, and you weren't sure what you were going to get after the turmoil of the week that they went through. Odell Haggins named the head coach after Willie Taggart was let go on Sunday. But they just kept reminding each other that, you know, Haggins, he's one of us. He knows where we are, and he certainly took them where they wanted to be with the win on the road.
On third down, intercepted over the middle. Davis for the Hornets. Urshot Davis, the freshman, with a pick early in this third quarter for the Hornets.
Carroll City Chief, talk about the great programs, not only in the state of Florida, but in the nation. And you know what? Just wanting it more. It runs right through the intended receiver, DJ Matthews. How many times have we seen offensively Alabama State, the receivers going up and fighting for that football? Here's one more look at it. But just coming out of that break and just rounding into it like it's just going to happen. You got to go attack that football and just wanting it more than DJ Matthews and putting his offense in a great situation after the interception by Blackman, who's had a pretty good game to start.
Davis back to pass. That one was almost picked off. Akeem Dent stepping in front of the receiver and knocking it down. Tariq Allen was the intended receiver.
Well, Akeem Dent, that's the second time this game he's had his hands on the football. This one was way too easy. The other one was a little bit of a laser that was coming at him in a hurry, but he should have at least one and probably could have two interceptions in this game. Instead, living to play another down, Davis and company on second down and 10 now.
Interception by Urshot Davis was the first of the season for him and seventh of the year for the Hornets, as that's Gray on the rush. There is no game.
Dontavius Jackson, he wanted a flag. His helmet came off, so he'll have to leave the game. You know, he missed the Boston College game. They're lucky to have him back out there, the senior, playing on senior day here at Doak Campbell Stadium from Texas.
So third and 10, 5 of 12 in the game on third down. And trailing 21-6, early third quarter for Davis. Quick release, open man at the 20. Inside the 10 into the end zone and in. Jahad Booker for the Hornets on the touchdown from Davis. It goes for 33 yards.
Tom, we've seen a couple times in the first half where Florida State has brought a lot of bodies on the blitz, and they've let a back sneak out of the backfield for a completion for a couple yards. It's one thing to let a guy sneak out and get a couple yards, but it's another to leave one wide open down the field for an easy touchdown like this. If you're going to bring guys, you better get there one. If you don't get there, you better have somebody over the top to keep those receivers in front of you. And this quick game, you know, even though when you are untouched, it's a quarterback in Davis that has not panicked. With all those guys in his face, they'll line up and go for two.
And the snap gets away, and Davis can only fall on it. So the failed two-point conversion, but they went officially for 34 yards on the touchdown play. Davis to Booker for the Hornets.
Go to LLS.org.
The ACC basketball doubleheader tips off Wednesday at 6:30 on Fox Sports South.
All right, welcome back. Let's see if we can take another look at the miscommunication on the Honda power play, a power play for the Alabama State offense, of course, the Hornets. And there's the blitzers. You're going to see everybody coming from the right side of the defense as you look at them for Davis and not panicking. And the miscommunication is going to be here between the secondary of Florida State, letting guys run free. It's Nasruddin, who's up there really close in the box.
This is Bolden on the return at the sideline, and they finally get him out of bounds after our power play brought to you by Honda Generators was the TD by the Hornets of 34 yards from Davis to Booker, and then the return. Isaiah Bolden. 34 yards on this return, James.
Special teams helping them out. It was a special teams play for Alabama State to get things going. A little bit of the energy. And Johnson's going to get over there on the stop, but the damage is done after the touchdown. Florida State in excellent field position. There is second time they've touched the ball in the second half.
Alabama State has very little experience against the football bowl subdivision, although they did play at Auburn a season ago and lost 63-9.
And they have never played a team out of the ACC until today. And they trail 21-12.
Good Christian Clark there. He's got a better place for the Kansas City Chiefs. Here goes Blackman.
Inside the five before they get him, James.
Looks like he's all right. He looked like he was banged up a little bit. And a nice job by that offensive line there on the left side. And a good job blocking down the field as well. That's Jordan Young, the redshirt freshman, helping his quarterback make it even more.
35 yards, previous play to the goal line. And just short of it, Laburn. He's already got a TD run of 4 yards in this game that came in the first quarter. A sophomore from Virginia Beach, Virginia, 5'11 and 205. And in the red zone, once again for Florida State, they are 1-for-1. The CPI Security red zone. Touchdown in the red zone today for the Seminoles. ...87% of the season in the red zone. And Blackman is moving carefully on the sideline as Jordan Travis is in to the goal line and into the end zone. Laburn, yard away, second TD for number 4 on the afternoon.
Kalen Laburn, a little bit more of a finesse guy, but you don't need any finesse. You just need a little bit of grit to get it 1 yard out into the paint, and that's not what you want to see Florida State just when James Blackman starting to play a little bit better football over there on the sidelines. And Jordan Travis, who came in to get on that bike, who came in to take that snap and saw some action against Boston College, a transfer from Louisville.
Aguayo. 28-12. FSU, James.
There you go. Touchdown number 2 for the sophomore from Virginia Beach. Making it look easy after the nice kick return.
On Fox Sports South. All is brought to you by Synovus, the bank of here. LS Tractor. See the LS difference at lstractorusa.com. And Toyota. Visit your local Toyota dealers today. Toyota, let's go places.
That national championship trophy from 2013. 3 times national champs here in Tallahassee. And Laburn went to the end zone for the second time after a Blackman run of 35 yards, but he came out of the game and seemed to be walking around that sideline carefully with his team up 28-12. No return of the kickoff. To check in with Kelsey Moore on Blackman on the sidelines. Kelsey?
Yeah, he was limping around on the sidelines, got on the bike as you saw, and he did just walk into the tent here. He was trying to do a little bit of warm-ups and immediately walked into this tent for the time being, guys.
So James Blackman, the sophomore, South Bay, Florida. We told you that the last time Florida State was in a bowl game was 2017, the Independence Bowl. Blackman threw 4 touchdown passes in that game. That was a bowl record for that game, and he was also the offensive MVP. So he's been around this program. 39 career TD passes with the 2 today to Harrison and Terry, but being evaluated in the medical tent on the Knoll sideline at the moment. From the 25 for Alabama State, we're going to swing this one wide. Duran Bell, sophomore from Tampa, Florida, first down. And an even 10 yards for Bell.
Bell, one of many transfers from USF down in Tampa. And a good job blocking there by Michael Jefferson, the leading receiver on this team.
Up the middle with Ezra Gray. 3 yards.
Kelsey off the top. She talked about a head coach setting an example. And Donald Hill Ely, the head coach for Alabama State. And here's a guy, 4.0 GPA, Ezra Gray, who falls in line with that, the senior from Lynn Haven, Florida.
This pass out to Gray down the sideline with a first down and more. Ezra Gray. And for more, number 20 for Alabama State, we go down to Kelsey.
Yeah, James, you mentioned it. A senior with a 4.0 GPA, and it's in computer information systems. But he said that comes from his household. It was only expected of them to get A's and B's. But when he got to college, he said he challenged himself even more to put in his best effort academically. And he's definitely done that. He's even currently taking a certification course in Swift programming. So after football, he told me he'd love to be an investor and invest in startup businesses or be an application development manager. He loves working with apps on Apple products.
Ooh. Okay. Thank you, boys.
The programmer is a big part of the program at Alabama State. And they're moving the ball again, James, to the 35.
Yeah, if he doesn't mind the grind off of the football field like he's been grinding on it, he's got a bright, bright future. Excellent job on and off the field.
Hand off. Gray. 3 yards.
Was 5'9", 167 pounds, but he's a load. I mean, there's a burst and some determination every time he gets his hands on that football. And he's just gotten better. You know, a lot of guys, you get to this time of the year, they start to get banged up a little bit, feeling sorry for themselves. He's going to take it to the final whistle. It sure looks like number 20.
Third down. Davis out of the pocket. Scampering his way for a first down inside the 30 for the Hornets. He's shaking up momentarily after he got five. That's a brave run by Davis.
Wow, what a great job here the last couple times. He's had some pressure and hasn't had a lot of pressure here this day. The quick game not there on this one. And he wants a flag at the end of that play. He won't get one, but his team will get a first down. A couple injured Seminoles on the field right now.
And Durden were able to get up and walk off the field for Florida State. Those are the players down, Emmett Rice and Corey Durden. And a first down scamper by Kadarius Davis, who was 21 of 30, 237 yards and a touchdown pass. Physical tackle out on the edge. Allen was the receiver. Brendan Gant, who just came in for Emmett Rice.
He came in hungry. Good job closing on it, you know. And you would say the coaching point there for next time is the motor down, come under control, or I guess you could just give him the big haymaker right across the chest. Lucky it wasn't a little bit higher, but 44 getting after it, trying to make something happen.
Just 2 yards of that previous play. The pass is complete. Tyreek Allen trying to shake his man near the 20-yard line. Doesn't quite get there. Nasruddin forced him out after 6 yards to number 8, the senior from San Antonio, Texas, Tyreek Allen.
Well, where has this offense of Alabama State had some success? You know, you've tried to pressure them, and it's such a quick game, you're unable to get there and affect it. So you got to play a little bit more aggressive outside, and they just let them kind of just chip away at that. Another third down and short situation because of it.
Credit to Joe Blackwell, the offensive coordinator for the Hornets. They put in a pretty good game plan, installed a nice offensive game plan so far today.
I would agree with that, Tom. It takes the players out there executing and playing hard as well, and they've done just that.
Third and two. The pressure was coming from the nose. A floater near the five and punched away incomplete. Allen was down there as the receiver for the Hornets. Dent, able to punch it away like a soccer keeper.
Absolutely. Here the pressure is going to get to Davis. It's right there in his lap again. He doesn't panic. He gets the ball out there, and a nice job to recover by the freshman from Pahokee. Dent is going to knock it away when those eyes get big and the hands go up. And a good
job to force a field goal try here.
Fifth chance of the day for Hunter Hansen. He's 2 for 4. This is from 38 yards away. He has made from 19 and 35 yards. And that one, a little too much hooking action. And he's now 2 for 5 in the afternoon. A 35-yarder and a miss from Hansen. Bop.
Yeah. 9 points. Right. 3 missed field goals. And look at that. It's a touchdown is the difference in this football game. Just a couple opportunities to get down there and make a game of it, but unable to convert.
And before we continue, James, a quick word from Works.
The Works Tri-Vac 3-in-1 Easy Switch from Blow2Vac is a game changer and a time saver. Your yard work champion.
So 9 points left out there and missed field goals by the Alabama State Hornets. Jordan Travis, just a yard. Redshirt freshman, West Palm Beach, Florida. An impressive debut, to say the least, a week ago against Boston College. As we told you, his first snap was a 26-yard TD run in the third quarter. And then the 66-yard TD run with 1:03 left proved to be the game-winning points against the Eagles. Longest TD run by a FSU quarterback in the history of the program. And there is a Hornets player down with 7:13 to go in the third.
Yeah, that's Kamar Martin, who's had such a big game there in the secondary.
Jordan Travis, James, is our Hardy's star to watch. Look at the numbers. Just 3 carries and 94 yards a week ago against the Eagles.
Yeah, he actually played for my old roommate at the University of Florida. Eric Kresser was his high school coach at the Benjamin School. And talked to Kresser yesterday about Jordan Travis, who started off his career at Louisville before transferring down. And with the coaching change from Petrino to Satterfield, he wanted to come back down to the Sunshine State. And, well, if you listen to Kresser, he's the best one here on campus. But that's my man, Kresser. You know, and that's the thing. Can he throw it like he can run it? And the answer, if you talk to not only his high school coach, but his coach right now, and Kendall Briles, the answer is absolutely yes. Briles went and watched him when he was with the Benjamin School while he was at FAU. He said he watched him throw. I watched him throw about 80 balls in warm-ups, and not one was off target. So I offered him right there on the spot. So a lot of talent, a lot of young talent still here. James Blackman, hopefully he's going to be okay. Kelsey mentioned earlier he's over there getting tended to. But right now, it's the Jordan Travis show for the redshirt freshman from West Palm.
Only played in 3 games for Louisville and then redshirted last year. So Travis, the 2 TD runs of 26 and 66 yards against BC last week, and a 38-31 victory for Florida State. It's 5th of the season. Laburn just to Nicholas Terry, number 16, black and gold and white of Alabama State. The Hornets taking it up a notch this week to take on Florida State, the first ever meeting between the teams. This is 3rd and 6, and Laburn is well short of the marker by maybe 2 or 3 yards. Devin Booker making the tackle for the Hornets, and that brings up 4th down.
Well, wow, it's, you know, Alabama State, you talk about them kicking it up a notch competition-wise. And they're fighting. I mean, it's not like they've been overmatched throughout the day. You've seen them give up a few explosive plays. But they're in there fighting away and trying to make a football game out of it. And one more 3 and out. Give their offense another chance to march it back down there.
Hunt from Martin. Crab signals for the fair catch. It's a mini adventure at the 30, but he makes it. 41 yards on the punt from Tommy Martin, the sophomore. Kadarius Davis, accurate.
Well, he's just gotten into a nice little rhythm here with his receivers. And not only is he throwing the ball well, but his receivers are taken care of. And we've seen a lot of drops in, you know, college football and in our games and across the college football landscape this year. But not from these guys today. Davis is putting it up there, and his guy is going up and pulling it down, and a lot of times in heavy traffic. Here we go as we go down the wire in this one, though. Let's see if Davis and company can go and get one in the end zone one more time, because the field goal tries. Well, it's been too much of an adventure for them with all the misses.
Davis threw three touchdown passes last week in the win at Texas Southern, 27-21. For the fifth win of the year for the Hornets. That's 6 yards on the run by Ezra Gray. Played in front of a record crowd at their home stadium on September 7th against Tuskegee in a win 38-31. Almost 28,000 people watching that victory for the Hornets against Tuskegee. Alabama State, East Division in the SWAC. Left side, bouncing up near the 40-yard line, and enough for a first down is Ezra Gray. He was cut down by Gant.
You know, again, you go back to last weekend at halftime in Boston, where Odell Higgins challenged his guys. He said, you know what, man, it's time to grow up, and it's time to finish. This is one of those times. This is one of those. It's, you're supposed to be bigger, stronger, faster, and better up front. You got to win those one-on-one battles.
Determined running from Gray gets him to the 45-yard line. Dontavius Jackson on the tackle. Number 5 in Garnet and Gold. He's a senior. Leave Texas.
We saw him and Rice leave the game earlier in. Dontavius Jackson is another guy that's been injured. They're at the linebacker spot, but it's still no excuse now. It's a second down and 5 after a 5-yard pickup on that first down.
Near midfield and caught by Allen in a congested area. A couple of defenders there for FSU. 4, maybe 5 yards. Maybe not quite enough here to get those chains rolling. Just a few inches short, maybe the width of the chalk line. This is third and truly third and inches.
Couple third and ones they've converted just by running it right up the gut with Gray. Let's see if they go right back to it.
They've been good this season, 39% as a team, and they've got it. 3 yards. Ezra Gray. Dent and Jackson combined on the stop, but not before a first down.
Good job by the offensive line. Look at him up front. You've got Leeward Brown wins that one-on-one battle. And it's just, you know, it goes without saying, no pad wins in this situation. But it's also a little bit of want to. Warner's getting pushed out of the way there. You got to hold your ground and help out your teammates. Too easy for Alabama State there.
And that pass is complete on the edge to Allen. We got 4 yards on that play. Nasrul Dean defensively for Florida State. 5 catches, Tariq Allen.
Look at that. 292 and 293 in the time of possession, heavily in favor of Alabama State. Florida State better be careful there. That right end looked like Dennis Briggs was lined up offsides. Now he'll get back and put his hand down.
Davis has used 7 different receivers in this game. Hand it off. Back to the line of scrimmage for Gray. And no further. And inside of 2 minutes to play in the third. Briggs Jr. Redshirt freshman. 6'4 and 268 pounds. Part of the future of this Noles program. Coach Hagan's part of the future. You name a head coach. We talked about that at halftime. James, I like your opinions about that, but I was most impressed in talking to that gentleman.
Absolutely. Boy, he's right now, he's got a football team, though, that Alabama State hits their 3 field goals. They could be driving down to tie it up right now.
So he's got a lot on his plate. His defense has got to step up and make a play now.
Davis through the progression, intercepted at the 20. The receiver fell down. Nasruldeen has the football. He's up to the 40. Broke a couple tackles. One man to get by for Nasruldeen. And all the way to the end zone on the return. Hamza Nasruldeen. Enough gas to go 80 yards on the return from Florida State. Michael Jefferson tried to hustle back and run him down.
Well, receiver's going to fall down. And Nasruldeen, who has been so good against the run, coming off a career day, more tackles last week against BC than any Noel in over 50 years. And here, it pays off through the air as well. Makes a few guys miss, and then he's got one big boy to give a little shake to. A nice hustle play, almost getting him from behind is Michael Jefferson, but it won't happen in a defensive touchdown. Big-time play by the Noles D.
His second interception of the season, goes back 80 yards for the return for a touchdown. Get that man some oxygen. 35-12, Florida State. It is our Toyota Let's Go Places, and they are going to the end zone on the pick.
Well, the ball is underthrown as it is. Even if the receiver, the intended target from Davis, doesn't fall down, Nasruldeen still in position to get that football. There was no miscommunication here. Only communication you needed was help me pick up a few blocks. And it's off to the races, and his buddies over there giving him a pat on the head.
See, they've got the camouflage shirts on Military Appreciation Day. Interception number two, but the first interception by the Noles this year, taken back for a touchdown. They had six interceptions on the season prior to that one by Nasruldeen. He's the only player on the team with multiple interceptions this season.
Well, maybe back-to-back ACC Defensive Back of the Week awards coming his way. He's the reigning Defensive Back of the Week in the ACC.
It's an exciting moment for that young man, the junior from Concord, North Carolina. Good size in that back line at 6'4", 215, and fans of all ages here at Doak Campbell Stadium enjoyed that one. 80 yards. Levante Taylor had an interception return for a touchdown last season in the win against Samford of 63 yards, and that's the last time Florida State was able to take an interception back for a touchdown. The one by Taylor last year won the game for him against Samford. We were here for that one. But last year, the Noles ended up 5-7, 3-5, and that interrupted a string of 36 straight bowl appearances. Should they win today, James, they will be bowl eligible with one more game to play this season in a couple weeks against Florida.
After that streak of 36 years in a row of going bowling, trying to start a new streak with one in a row for Odell Higgins. They're the eligible teams in the ACC. A couple knocking on the door. Georgia Tech and Syracuse will not participate this year. It's not enough wins. Nothing else keeping them up.
Clemson and Wake Forest playing today. That at Memorial Stadium, Clemson, South Carolina, and the Tigers trying to go for 26 wins in a row. The record is held by Florida State with 29 in a row. And you also saw Louisville on that list for teams that could potentially be bowl eligible. What a turnaround for them and Scott Satterfield.
Absolutely. That to me has been the biggest surprise in the ACC this year. It just looked like they had so much work to do. And the mindset, you know, of those players last year. I had Louisville a couple times last year, and there wasn't a whole lot of fight in them. And for them to go in there and turn around the mentality of that team is really remarkable. Big things to come in Louisville.
Ja'Cory Merritt on the run, dragging the pile up close to the 35-yard line. 7 yards and a first down. We get that indication from field level. And so Florida State with its 35-12 lead
after the return by Nasrul Dean. And a touchdown return of 80 yards late in this third quarter.
Well, Rice looked like he was limping a little bit, but he's going to stay out there. He's already left the field with an injury here today.
That is the end of the third. Florida State has the lead over Alabama State, 35-12. The fourth is straight ahead. And we welcome you into the fourth. It's presented by Lincoln Financial. Tom Wormy, James Bates from our broadcast position here at Doak Campbell Stadium. Some exciting plays by the Noles today. James, they started the game with that long TD pass, 69 yards, and then Nasrul Dean, 80 yards on the interception return for a touchdown.
Yeah, it's good to see a leader like that. And you can tell how much the team cares for him. You see all of his buddies over there just loving him up, giving him the hugs and pats on the back after he had the touchdown run. But therein lies the rub. He's been the guy that's been making all the plays. This, you know, we've talked about off the top that this isn't the Florida State team of old, and doesn't Odell Hagans know that? Defensively, these teams, they have a mentality of dominating, and there hasn't been a whole lot of plays when they've needed them from guys across the board. That's what they came here for. You'd like to see it spread out a little bit better in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, Alabama State has been competitive in this game, but Florida State, should it win today, I think it's a step in a very positive direction, regardless of what they do, as far as the head coaching position is concerned, whether it's Odell Hagans or whether it's somebody else, they would have a chance to return to a bowl game, and they would get back in the postseason. So we'll see what they can do to finish this one off against Alabama State. We thank you for watching the fourth. It's been presented by Lincoln Financial.
Running newer, longer.
Fixed right, priced right, right on time. The triple promise, only at Firestone Complete Auto Care.
Through three quarters, time of possession favors the Hornets. The scoreboard favors the Noles. 256 yards through the air for Alabama State. Kadarius Davis, their quarterback, and that's incomplete. Despite that incompletion, Davis has been impressive. Hasn't backed down one bit from the Noles.
Well, you haven't had a whole lot of that. Maybe just the second ball that could have been dropped here today, dropped by one of his receivers. They've been taking care of him. His offensive line has two. Through three quarters of play, Donald Hill Ely and his coaching staff have to be happy with the way their guys have gotten out there and competed.
26 of 36 through the air for Davis. There is no option here. That pocket crumbles right in front of him. Drew Thompson celebrates the sack and a loss of three.
True that. Just a freshman. Again, these youngsters. Here he is over on that left side. Just going to get down low and walking back to the quarterback, and a good job of using his hands, separating, coming down and making the play. But now, consistency, back it up, back-to-back plays where you just smother an offense is what you expect when you talk Florida State football on the defensive side of the ball.
Third and 13. Merritt took on the contact, but well short of the marker, just 5 yards on the play. Ja'Cory Merritt's a freshman from Montgomery, Alabama. That is the location of Alabama State enrollment, 5,627 playing in the Football Championship Subdivision and the SWAC East Division. They can still win the East. They need help, but they can still win the East. They've been SWAC champs twice in their history, 04 and 91, and HBCU national champs back in 1991. Alabama State, this Hornet program. DJ Matthews is deep. Good play on the snap by Craven. Matthews, what are you going to do? Cover at the 10. The punt was 52 yards, and there was no return. In all of the nation. 3:30. Check your local listings for Virginia Tech and Georgia Tech.
Glitter boys. That'll be chilly today. How about Virginia Tech? They get a win today against Georgia Tech, one step closer to maybe Clash of the Titans in the Coastal to end the season in Charlottesville. And this is a Virginia team that's on top right now, but they haven't beaten Virginia Tech, Tom, in 15 years. Virginia Tech's won four of their last five. They've done a good job of turning things around.
Blackman. Deep ball. Caught at midfield. And now the ball comes out at the tail end of the play. And it's scooped up. And there's also a flag. In fact, there's two penalty markers. So the catch was made. Covered by Martin. 88 is Treshawn Harrison. And then it was covered by Kamar Martin. Okay, and there are two flags. There's Jeff McConaughey.
During the return, illegal block in the back, intercepting team. 10-yard penalty, first down.
Wow, so Harrison, who had the touchdown in the first half, was going to be a big-time hitter right here, a nicely thrown football, and a good job of adjusting, going back and getting it off his near side hip, and unable to secure it and tuck it away. A good job to continue fighting by the Hornets, and it's Alabama State football one more time.
It's Davis who pulls it away. Earshot Davis is 22 and white. He takes it away from Harrison, and then Martin picks it up, and there was a penalty on the return after the change of possession. So the ball, after all that, is spotted at the 36-yard line. First and 10. James, we should also mention, you were talking about the Coastal Division. How about Pittsburgh? Now, they're the defending champs of the Coastal, and they won in overtime against North Carolina at home on Thursday.
Right. Big win for them.
So add that to the brew.
Here's Jed Even, the new quarterback for Alabama State. You know, I'm going to go back to one thing again, you might be tired of hearing me say this, but that right there is an example of Odell Higgins saying, it's time to grow up. That ball is caught by Harrison. It's time to grow up and be a man. We just watched highlights when we went to break of all these greats, the big playmakers at Florida State over the years. Those playmakers, they're not letting that ball ripped out of there. That's my big play. That's my quarterback's big play, and I'm going to do it for my team. It's got to matter to you more than it matters to the defense. Be a man and secure that rock. That means everything, the little things, and growing up is one of them, like Higgins continues to say.
That was the second turnover of the game for Florida State. Davis, who was the one who pried that ball loose from Harrison, had an interception in the third quarter. 35-12, 12:24 to go in the fourth. Tom Wormy, James Bates, Kelsey Wingard on the sidelines. So glad that you've joined us for ACC College Football. Featuring the Florida State Seminoles, one victory away from bowl eligibility for 2019. Back to a bowl for the first time in 2017, should they become eligible and receive a bid. Even. Plenty of air under that one, but incomplete. Allen was the receiver for the Hornets. And it's 4th and 11.
Still nothing to show for the turnover by his defense, Jed Even, on the offensive charge. A quick three and out, and they punt it away.
And they scored a touchdown off of that interception by Davis in the third quarter. But unable to harvest any points off of that turnover, with Even coming in as the second quarterback of record in the game for the Hornets. Matthews. Ranging to his right. Thought about circling back toward the middle of the field. All over the map and finally taken down. At about the 16, 17-yard line. The punt was 46 yards. And the return, all that was a yard from Matthews.
The DJ Matthews, who battled the flu last week going into that Boston College game and actually had IVs, had to wake up at 5 a.m. in Boston, get hooked up to the IVs. He had been so sick. And Coach Higgins asked him if he was ready to go, if he thought he could make it. He said, absolutely, I'm doing it for you, Coach, and went out and had that 60-yard touchdown catch. Put the Florida State Seminoles on top late in the game.
And that was with just 1:48 to go in the game as he dove for the pylon. And Florida State went ahead to stay in that game against BC. We saw that Jordan Travis is back out there at quarterback for Florida State. And James, I would reference something that Coach Higgins told us in our meetings yesterday. I asked him what was the galvanizing factor as far as the win on the road at BC was concerned. And he said it was the look in the eyes of the guys at 7 a.m. rolling in for a special teams meeting. Normally, maybe a little groggy, a little blurry. He saw a steely, determined focus from his group, and he knew they had a very good shot of beating the Eagles, and they did.
Yeah, he looked over at me, and he goes, you know what I mean when I say they don't want to get up early. And it's, you know, it's, you wouldn't think it'd be college football players, but they're college kids at the end of the day. And they don't all like waking up early. But he knew there was no grogginess. Said to his assistant coach, we're going to win this football game. Look at their eyes.
Neighbors, number 32, 4 yards.
Trey McKitty, the tight end, unable to go today with that bad ankle. Played hurt last weekend, the junior. Hopefully he'll be okay for the Florida game.
Same with Cam Akers in the backfield for Florida State.
Uh-oh.
There's plenty on this run by Travis. Down the sideline, trying to get past one man and shoved out of bounds. Jordan Travis on the run for Florida State, and Hill had to force him out before the goal line.
Almost another home run for a guy whose brother Devin was a baseball star here, for Mike Martin. Look at him out there in open field, and look at his guys hustling for him. And good hustle by Alabama State to force him out of bounds, as well as Joshua Hill to save the day. But it's first and goal, Seminoles.
61-yard run, Jordan Travis. Looking into the end zone. Pursued. Throws to the goal line and incomplete. Again, looking for Gabe Neighbors, the senior. One of 19 seniors honored today in their final home game. Bobby Bowden Field at Doak Campbell Stadium. First opened up back in 1950. 302 all-time wins on this field. In fact, number 300 came September 21st against Louisville earlier this season. All right, second and goal. Blackman back in at quarterback. Quick throw. Back corner. Terry was the receiver. Keenan and Isaac, they're still tangled up. Now Terry helps up Isaac.
Oh, yeah. He helped him down, too. He helped him down, but then he helped him back up, so he's even.
Physical play by that duo in the back corner.
Yeah, they had the one-on-one, tried to take advantage of the big body. And there you see, getting away with a little bit of a hole, Keenan Isaac. Not to be confused with Keenan Isaac Wayans. Keenan Ivory Wayans.
How about that sign, James?
There you go.
We know who she wants.
It's nothing, anything.
As the next head coach.
3-0 Odell. Trying to move to 4-0 Odell.
Offensive 51. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
Johnson, center. Penalty. FSU.
Too much of it. Look at the face of Odell Higgins. He knows.
Second stint as the interim head coach. Did it at the end of 2017 as well, and won both of those ball games. Inside of 10 minutes to go in regulation.
Different situation, too, in taking over the two times. Different mentality by the football team.
Let that play clock go way down. Flag came out. Blackman on a run. A wide open man in the end zone for the score to Terry. It's 7 yards if it stands. There is a penalty marker on the field.
Illegal motion. Offensive 4. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
first and goal inside the five. But a couple of penalties have pushed the Noles back, and that one against Laban.
Again, this gentleman right here, you know, everybody's fighting. You saw the sign, hire Odell, and all the support from the former players, from his teammates, from the great Noles, from his current players. To give him a shot, they've got to go beat Florida in 2 weeks. But they can't do it if they continue to shoot themselves in the foot with just these unforced errors like that time and time again.
On third and goal to the end zone, and a strike from Blackman to Matthews. Touchdown FSU of 12 yards.
DJ Matthews on the mix. You see him scratching a little bit there, celebrating.
The junior from Jacksonville takes one right to the chest from James Blackman. Good to see him back out there. He was banged up earlier. Good protection. And going up and making sure he locks in. See that?
This sound effects, James.
Well, that's what a DJ does.
Good work.
A DJ catches touchdown passes and
on the ones scratches. On the ones and twos? They still say that?
Yep. I doubt it.
Oh, man. 42-12. So Blackman's hit three different receivers for touchdowns. This time it's DJ Matthews.
The turntables might wobble, but they don't fall down.
Big 12 football, all season long.
Another TD pass of 12 yards. James Blackman to DJ Matthews and Coach Odell Hagans. With some teaching moments with both of those young men during the course of this afternoon.
Yeah, a little tough love earlier. That was after the punt that he didn't pick up. He let it roll, gave Alabama State a free about 15, 20 yards. Speaking of love, a little kiss on the face mask for you, James Blackman. And you know, and that's the word love. He actually said that you don't hear the word love coming off the lips of men very much, but you need to hear it more, and these kids need to hear it more. And we certainly heard about it a lot. And his love not only for Florida State University, but all these kids on this football team right now.
Talking to Coach Higgins, he said after he was named interim, he called Coach Bowden, he called Mickey Andrews, he called Coach Gladden, Coach Burnham, and he said he just wanted to thank them for doing it the Florida State way, for teaching him as much as they did. And they told him, you know, what you see in me now, this is what I learned from you guys and my mother. He said that they instilled integrity and character on them, and they never quit. And you see that in Higgins. He never quits on these players. And he learned that from a lot of former coaches here at Florida State. And he said, most importantly, those coaches pushed them hard, and they taught them about life. He said, you can learn so much about life with football. And he said the best piece of advice he got from Coach Andrews was create great habits, because when adversity hits, those great habits are going to come out. And that is exactly what Coach Higgins is trying to instill in his players, guys.
100%, Kelsey. And he mentioned his mom and a mother back in Polk County that raised four boys. He was the youngest. And he just said that's really what drove him early. He said he never wanted to let his mom down. He wanted to make her proud. And she always reminded him to be a positive influence and to make people around you happy. And there's certainly more happiness when you're winning football games in Tallahassee and 9 minutes and 10 seconds away from moving to 4-0 as the head coach of his beloved Seminoles.
There was a local Little League football coach who asked Odell's late mother about the four boys standing around and they want to play football, and the rest, as they say, is history. Is that what pops in the air? There's a flag on the play. Raymond Woody has the football. Number 31 inside the 20 for Woody and out of bounds. So it just kind of popped up in the air at the end of the play. There is a flag on the play. And it was thrown in the vicinity of the interception.
Prior to the interception, pass interference, defense number 12. 15-yard penalty, first down.
Raymond Woody, the son of the linebacker coach Coach Woody, a big play that's going to be wiped away because of the pass interference. It was called, and gosh, Litton, who's just running by and trying to slow himself down, and gets a hand up there, and the flag comes out. So, well, another big defensive play. We saw the nice interception return by Nazrul Dean earlier for a touchdown. And this one will come back and go back into the hands of Alabama State.
Michael Jefferson was the receiver for the Hornets involved in that previous play. Merritt. And near the 40-yard line for Ja'Cory Merritt, the freshman. And that run for 17 yards. And that is the longest rush of the game for the Hornets. Litton had to force him out. Hornets with their second quarterback of the afternoon, and Jet Even, the graduate student from Portland, Oregon, is in at quarterback, replacing Kadarius Davis. Strong performance from Davis in what will most likely be the losing effort, trailing 42-12 late in this one. There is no gain from Merritt. Alabama State facing its second football bowl subdivision opponent of the season, losing to UAB in late August. That at Legion Field in Birmingham, Alabama, 24-19. The head coach, Donald Hill Ely, in his third season.
And you know what, Tom? Drew Thompson just made a tackle for a loss, and he had to help himself up. Nobody patted him on the butt. It's just, you like to see these guys celebrate together, hunt together, celebrate together. Just, that's where the energy comes into play.
Intercepted. Samuels. Flag on the play. Well behind the play. Jet Evans' pass sailed just enough for Stanford Samuels to run under it. And his return back was 47 yards, but once again, there's a penalty marker. It's way back at the 15-yard line.
After the interception, personal foul, blindside block. Intercepting team number 44. 15-yard penalty. Florida State retains possession. First down.
Well, they'll keep this one at least, and that's back-to-back interceptions for Stanford Samuels. Last week, a great big one in the fourth quarter with the Eagles driving. There you see him up top, number 8. His eyes on that football. He just runs right underneath it, a little bit overthrown. And Jefferson didn't get a hand on it. Some big plays in that Boston College game, and here's a nice-looking run back for the junior after the interception. They'll march it back a little bit, though, with the blindside block. And there's Odell Hagans coaching up Gant, the young linebacker. Blindside block, something. Here are the new rules, or point of emphasis here in this 2019 season. You can use your hands from coming from the side, but you can't go in and... Those big blows, that's what you used to see. And that's when you talk about making college football safer. We'll take another look at it. And there it is. And that's just dangerous. And he's actually lucky that they don't tack anything onto that, because then you're talking about missing the rest of this game and, of course, the Florida game first half. You've already got a banged-up linebacker.
Basketball doubleheader tips off Wednesday at 6:30 Eastern on Fox Sports South and Fox Sports Go.
Well, we welcome you back. 42-12, Florida State on top, and after an interception by Florida State, Stanford Samuels, the cornerback, getting word that the replay officials are taking a look up top. You see there the blindside block. The flag was thrown. And
after
Dan Posey,
there was a foul for targeting defense number 44. Florida State number 4 is disqualified. Retain possession, first down.
Keith Roden, Dan Post, the replay officials. And it, one of the things that they can do here in recent years is add on. Go upstairs and add on. There wasn't a targeting called on the field. But now Gann, again, we told you, Dontavius Jackson missed last week. He's banged up with the hand injury. Emmett Rice has left the game twice here today.
So a thin linebacking core, and now Brendan Gant misses the rest of this game, but more importantly, after the bye week, he'll miss the first half in the Swamp in Gainesville in a big game against Florida to end the regular season. And that's something that they work on time and time again, those blindside blocks. You can't get away with them, let alone the targeting. That's costly.
Travis on the pass out by the boundary. Just 3 yards on the play for Florida State, and that was Darius Dent, the sophomore, on the catch. By the way, Florida State lost here at home last year to Florida 41-14. Last time they were in the Swamp was 2017, and they won at Florida 38-22. Big hit at the 30, and a flag came out. Joshua Hill with the hit on Dent. So Joshua Hill, number 24, came over 19 yards if the play stands. And we just had Gant removed from the game for targeting.
Personal foul. Targeting. Defense number 24. 15-yard penalty. The woman of targeting is under further review.
All right, so here's what they look at now with Joshua Hill. You see the big lick trying to dislodge the ball. Remember, it isn't just targeting of a defenseless player on offense, but you're trying to protect the defensive player. So they're trying to protect his head as well. And the targeting, if it is called, will be because he led with the crown. We'll check on it. Let you know when we come back.
And everyone who counts on you. See how Lincoln can help.
Here's a look at that previous play with the Noles up 42-12. The review was for targeting. Dent made the catch, and that was Joshua Hill in white number 24. And after the review, there was no targeting, and the play was ruled an incomplete pass. So there is no flag on the play because the flag initially was for targeting, not supported by the replay, and an incomplete pass. 6:29 to go, 3rd and 7. And Jordan Travis, the freshman, is in there at quarterback. Travis with a pirouette and then gets knocked down at the 10-yard line. Andrew Ogletree. Travis, he ran about 20 yards on the play, but officially got zero back to the line of scrimmage. So he tried to make something happen. It just did not materialize. Tommy Martin's going to stand in his own end zone to punt. Crab is the deep man. Standing at his 47 is Martin. Steps across the goal line. This one bounces. Did it hit someone? Looked like it might have hit a white shirted player. The punt was 44 yards. And there was no return. Trying to hit Dontre Manley, who was running back, trying to provide some blocking for the return man, Crab. Either way, 5:40 to go. And Coach Hagans and the Noles zeroing in on their sixth win of the season. They'd improve to 6-5. And 5-2 at home this season. They went 3-1 in conference play at home. They did lose, though, November 2nd against Miami, and that set off a chain reaction. The dismissal of Willie Taggart. Coach Hagans taking over on an interim basis. And as we've mentioned on a number of occasions, in 2 weeks, they've got a game at Florida. And last time they were there, 2 years ago, they defeated the Gators.
Personal foul. Hands in the face. Offense number 16, 15-yard penalty. First down.
That was a freshman year for James Blackman, where he had 12 starts, the most by a freshman in school history.
And a foul called on Carl Thompson. One of many from the Miami pipeline. You can see him right in the middle there. Gets the hands up underneath Lamar. Good look at it. A senior from Miami, Jackson. We saw the mighty marching Hornet band here at halftime. at Miami Jackson, when Miami Jackson and Miami Northwestern, when they get it on down in the bottom in the Soul Bowl, those bands, that's a lot like some of these, like the Marching 100, some of these great shows.
The Marching Hornets have provided the soundtrack for our game this afternoon, along with the Marching Chiefs from Florida State.
Right on cue. They give you a little chant. Well, you know, no shoulder pads, so maybe an injury that we didn't see out on the field for Kadarius Davis. But hats off to that young man. He came in and had just an outstanding day, running the show, very accurate, and never seemed to panic. One touchdown and one interception, but really did a good job, he and his offense, and his offensive coordinator, Joe Blackwell.
Davis threw three touchdown passes in a winning effort a season ago.
You know, you look at it, you say, oh, only 12 points scored, but they drove the football many times in this game. They missed the three field goal tries and hit a couple. Missed an extra point, so that's where the 12 comes from.
Career highs for Davis in completions and attempts in the game this afternoon against Florida State. First time that the Hornets and the Noles have ever met on the football field. Alabama State started playing in 1901. Norris on the run. First year of football here in Tallahassee, James, was 1947. Joined the ACC in 1992. Won 29 games in a row from 2012 to 2014, and won 29 in a row in the ACC from 92 to 95. That's an ACC record. So Matthews will be deep. Again, one of the key players not available to the Noles today was Cam Akers. He's a 1,000-yard rusher this season. He's got 2 years of 1,000 or more yards. He's only the third player in school history to do that, along with Dalvin Cook and Warwick Dunn. Booker makes a special teams tackle on Matthews. So the Noles here at Doak Campbell Stadium trying to return the program to its usual prominence. Get those numbers back up where they need to be, James. You've played in this stadium at full capacity, and you know what it's like in here.
Absolutely. And you need that. And it's, you know, it's the difference. That 12th man in 1996, we were number one, they were number two, and they beat us here. And the crowd has a lot to do with that. That atmosphere, when you got guys jumping off sides, you can't even hear what's going on when your team's on offense. And that gentleman right there certainly knows what that crowd means. And he said, hey, I'm going to say it. I'm going to basically beg you guys to come and fill this stadium. And there was a nice-sized crowd here today for it being early and cold. Alabama State coming to town. You know, a chance that it might rain. I think from what you're looking at, I think that more people showed up to support these seniors and to support Odell Hagan. So we did a good job of getting the word out there. But at the end of the day, you know, they go and start winning those football games more and more, and they'll pack it in a hurry. They love their football around here.
Over 52,000 today. And that is Sheffield down the sideline. And the Noles set the tone early. Their first play from scrimmage, after the Hornets had gone down and gotten a field goal and driven deep into Florida State territory, the first play from scrimmage was Blackman to Terry, 69 yards and a touchdown. They took the lead that they wouldn't give up. 17 yards on the previous play of the run from Sheffield. And a fun and emotional day for these seniors as well. 19 seniors honored prior to the game and honored by their teammates with the effort this afternoon, James, sending them out with a victory. Not only is it a win for the seniors, it is the sixth win of the season for Florida State, makes them bowl eligible. The penalties may be the only drawback of the day today for Florida State. And Coach Hagan's touched upon that, talking to Kelsey Winger at halftime. But for all that these young men have been through, on the field, off it as well, they may have the reward of a bowl trip in the near future. And they've got a big game coming up in a couple of weeks as they take on their rival, Florida. One of their rivals. That ball squirts loose and incomplete for McDonald, the sophomore. Coach Hagan says he doesn't worry about what's going to happen in the next couple weeks. James, the good Lord will take care of that, is what he told us. He just wanted to support his players today. And that's what they've done against an overmatched opponent, but Alabama State put up a really good fight. Their quarterback, Kadarius Davis, was impressive. Receiver Michael Jefferson, receiver Tyreek Allen, Ezra Gray. Nobody better than Ezra when they run the ball for the Hornets. This is down the middle of the field. Neighbors trying to get to the end zone, and they chase him down at the 2-yard line. And they'll mark him inside the 2. Joshua Hill had to chase him down. First and goal, 63 yards for the Noles on the play.
Yep, Georgia guy, it's a senior, trying to get the senior, sending him off right with the big play. Look at the big smile on Gabe Neighbors, who came here as a fullback from Lowndes High School, just over the border up in South Georgia, same high school that Randall Godfrey went to, great linebacker at the University of Georgia. Little pop pass. Good-looking runner for a guy who is a former fullback. And again, nice hustle. And if I'm not mistaken, it was Joshua Hill that saved a touchdown earlier in the football game.
That pass bounces just inside the goal line. Neighbors does have a couple of TDs receiving this season. And now just 34 seconds on the clock.
He's still smiling.
I mean, shouldn't the play be right back to Neighbors, number 32? He's got 2 catches for 68 yards in the game.
That was his chance. You got to leave him. Yeah, look at him. He's so mad he didn't score that touchdown.
The 68 yards, a career high in a game for Neighbors.
Senior day.
Goodness gracious. Came into the game with 10 catches and 2 TD grabs. Second and goal. Sheffield close to the goal line and in. There's the indication and a touchdown. Florida State from 2 yards away. Deontay Sheffield. First TD of the season for Sheffield.
Back up to Laburn, who's had a nice day near the goal line here today. Look at him get that body low and drive across. Just getting the tip of that football across the plane before he goes down, a former walk-on. A lot of hugs for Sheffield, and a lot of love for Odell. 4 and Odell, just about to be official.
Points on the board for Florida State. Kelsey Winger is going to chase down Coach Odell Hagans after the game, and we'll chat with him, get his reaction to this senior send-off. James, you know all about the emotion of your final game on your home field as a senior, everything that's gone on. Certainly the opponent today was one that they should have beaten, but Florida State securing and sealing the victory. Neighbors doesn't want to hear about it. He came up about a yard and a half short from his 3rd TD grab of the season.
Yeah, that was his buddy Trey McKinney over there. Who's nursing the bad ankle, giving him a hard time. Well, Kelsey better start stretching, because you saw that shot of him in uniform earlier, Odell Hagans. He can move it as a defensive tackle. In his playing career, his senior year, he had 100 tackles.
All-Americans.
That's a lot of tackles for a guy there on that defensive line.
Last week, he got doused with the sports drink. This week, he's going to get smothered in hugs by his players. Or is he trying to set up a wall just so they don't get him again? 4-0 for Odell. 49-12. So Florida State.
State will improve to 6-5, 5-2 at home this season. Bowl eligibility for the Noles.
Yeah, Tom, yesterday in the meeting, you mentioned Coach in his Gatorade bath, and everybody in the room looked at you. Hold on.
No.
It's Powerade.
I knew exactly what it was. Tip of the cap. And I think he's saluting all the fans that showed up to support his team to get their sixth win of the season. So that's two wins in a row since the loss here against Miami on November 2nd, a win at Boston College and a win against Alabama State open next week, and then it's at Florida. And once again, 2017, their last visit to the Swamp, Florida State defeated the Gators 38-22. Celebration is on the sidelines. 49 points, the most that Florida State has posted all season long.
And they've averaged over 40 points a game with Higgins as the head coach.
They have, and they kept that average up today. Final seconds of a win for the Florida State Seminoles. They did get them, and the Noles got the Hornets today. 49-12 is the final from Bobby Bowden Field, Doak Campbell Stadium. Win number 6 means that Florida State is bowl eligible after missing out of the party last year. 6-5 and one game to go against the Gators in a couple of weeks. Coach Donald Hill Ely for the Hornets. Hire Odell, we might find out in a couple of weeks, James, because that's the timetable that's been set by the administration here at FSU.
For Coach Higgins, I'm happy for these kids. Again, like we started this at the top of the show, right before they got here, they signed these seniors. This was a dominant power. They were the gossip in college football. And whether you love or hate Florida State football, I think you all can agree that they belong in the conversation. It just makes college football better. It just feels right when they're playing winning football. And a winning coach with Kelsey right now.
Thank you guys so much. Coach Higgins, you made it very clear to us this week that the only or the most important thing you were concerned about is making sure that your seniors went off on the right foot here at Doak. You guys put up 49 points, the most all season. How nice was it just to send them out of this stadium after everything they've been through on a winning note?
You know, it's awesome, you know, and we came out a little flat, and I told the guys, let's go out and play Florida State football. Made some mistake, but I tell you what, that's very important to me. These seniors done been through this twice, and the guy we won the game from, now we got a chance to go to a bowl. That's the main things for these kids. And not about Odell Higgins, it's about these kids.
You mentioned the bowl game. You guys just got that eligibility. But, you know, that's the expectation here for you guys to go to a bowl game. But is it nice to have that just completed and wrapped up and be able to just go on with the season knowing that you will go to a bowl game?
Yeah, you know, it's amazing. That's awful. That's awesome for our university. And, you know, you got to think about it. We're going to a bowl this year. A lot of kids say, Coach, we got to make it back to a bowl no matter what. We're going to make it to a bowl. They said that last week. And I'm so happy for it. I'm happy for the university, happy for our players.
What do you want to see the team clean up as you go into the bye week here?
Well, you know, I want to see them clean up the mistakes, the penalties. They were playing hard, but the penalties, that's unacceptable. We can't do that. And we're going to start cleaning up tomorrow. I promise you that. And they know it.
Well, Coach, congratulations on the win. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you very much. Appreciate you. Be blessed.
Kelsey, thank you. 4-0, 4-0 as the interim head coach in his second stint for the Florida State Seminoles. They celebrate the 49-12 victory over Alabama State. The first ever meeting between the teams. James Blackman throws 3 touchdown passes. 1 to Terry, 1 to Matthews, 1 to Harrison. It all adds up to a victory for Florida State. 49-12, their 6th of the season and bowl eligibility. Coming up next, Virginia Tech, Georgia Tech. That's from Atlanta. Georgia Tech has won the last 3 in the series. For James Bates, Kelsey Winger, and our outstanding production crew, I'm Tom Worthy saying so long from Bobby Bowden Field at Doak Campbell Stadium in Tallahassee, Florida.
Farms.